waking up this morning, but don't worry, we've got you covered. We're gonna heat things up for the next 3 hours, and we've got the perfect excuse to be inspired and start the week anew. Bring it on.
Yep, we want that refresh, and we are all about celebrating young, incredible people, our youth, and instilling a sense of passion, a sense of vigor, a sense of purpose in achieving their goals. And we're going to meet some incredible young achievers. Are we going to touch base with a figure skater who's just going to blow your mind, young Alex, to find out how she turned her hobby into a professional sport, and there is nothing slowing her down.
Yeah, especially at this age, it's only just going to get better, but we dive from this moment to another. 5FM have been on the hunt to find the best war cry within South Africa's schools. Yes, you heard correctly, and this morning we're going to find out which school took the win. I've heard the cheers when it comes to these anthems, and I'm telling you, it's going to be a vibe.
Oh, buddy, I was actually in Nick Hammond's studio while he was busy recording, getting one of these things. That feeling, there is nothing quite like it. It's going to be an incredible chance for you and your entire school to put your hands up. And then, of course, we're going to get some entertainment in this morning from the LMRI Dance Academy, the Limri Dance Academy, plus young singer-songwriter Liam Funahader, who sounds absolutely phenomenal. We've been sleeping on this kid, and he is going to wake up this morning and say, "You're mine." Okay, that's not actually what he's... Well, he might say it like
it's
that.
The new single.
Maybe he'll say it like that. But he is phenomenal. Seems like a wonderful young gent as well. So we will be inspired this morning.
Yeah, and of course, we're always inspired this morning to chat to you first up, Mzansi, and that's exactly what we're going to do this morning. We've got a Good Morning Boys coming through and asking you, what's the one rule you'd make and the law you'd make to ensure that people had a better work-life balance? I love this question, bro.
A law. I like that. We're not playing around with like a hint here. We want a law put down in black and white. How do you find that work-life balance? I know it can be very difficult. Maybe it requires a bit more structure. Maybe it requires our employers to think a bit more about our overall wellness. Whatever that is, we need to hit on it today. We want your inspiration, your input. So you can drop us a voice note, 063-408-8863. In fact, if you want to chat about anything, show any of these young achievers some love. But if you've got the key, you think, to finding that work-life balance, let us know. And we'll continue that conversation after we get the conversation started with some of those major talking points on the news front, and then of course I'll touch on the sport.
Yes, thank you so much, G-Man. Official duties must commence, and starting with national headlines. Now, gale force winds in the Western Cape yesterday caused widespread damage, including a trailer blown off a bridge near the Hoenoord Tunnel on the N1. Now, there were also reports of trees falling on homes and roads and severe traffic congestion. Now, incidents of roofs being ripped off were noted in Somerset West, Macassar, Mitchell's Plain and Clifton, with numerous homes still without power. Now, Western Cape Premier Alan Windey has declared school closures today in the Overberg, Cape Winelands and Helderberg areas due to anticipated heavy rainfall. Now, further updates in our weather report. Well, sticking to national headlines, President Cyril Ramaphosa joined other world leaders in Rwanda yesterday to mark 30 years since the genocide against ethnic Tutsis and moderate Hutus, in which some 800,000 people were killed. Now, he said SA had a good and special relationship with Rwanda over a number of years, and Rwandan President Paul Kagame commended South Africa for its support during difficult times in that country. Well, now moving to international headlines, and meanwhile, Rwanda's President Paul Kagame has said the international community, and quotes, failed all of us. Now, this as he marked 30 years since the 1994 genocide that killed some 800,000 people. Now, Kagame was addressing world leaders who had gathered at the Kigali Genocide Memorial in the Rwandan capital to commemorate the bloodshed. Now, Rwanda was completely humbled by the magnitude of our loss, Kagame said, and in 1994, extremists from the Hutu ethnic group launched a 100-day killing spree in which members of the Tutsi minority and Hutu moderates were killed. Next up in the headlines, millions are and have been hoping for clear skies ahead of today's total solar eclipse. Now, forecasters predict cloudy conditions in northern Mexico, Texas, and parts of the Great Lakes region in the U.S. Now, better weather is expected in western Mexico and parts of the U.S. Midwest, with clear spring skies likely in New England and Canada. But unfortunately, the celestial event won't be visible in South Africa. Now, the total solar eclipse, the first to cross the northern hemisphere since 2017, will first hit land on Mexico's west coast. Finally, in our headlines for this hour, world-famous primatologist Jane Goodall has celebrated her 90th birthday with a unique tribute. 90 top female photographers offering their work for sale over 90 days. Now, the initiative titled The Nature of Hope, 90 Years of Jane Goodall's Impact, features breathtaking images capturing nature's beauty, such as playful polar bears and snow geese taking flight. Now, the sale supports the Jane Goodall Institute's mission to protect chimpanzees and their habitats, with 60% of the proceeds benefiting this exact cause. Now, notable photographers, including Jodie MacDonald and Tao De Roy, contributed alongside Goodall's own historic self-portrait from her early days in Tanzania's Gombe Stream National Park. Now, this event not only honored Goodall's groundbreaking research, but also celebrated this wildlife's warrior's lasting influence on women worldwide. Well, we've got lots to still dive into, and let me tell you, sporting action took place this weekend. A moderate result for many, but G-Man has the latest when it comes to all the action.
So by moderate, we mean 1 point is all that Liverpool got out of their Premier League tie yesterday. And, of course, their title challenge a little bit hindered by goals from Bruno Fernandes and, of course, Kobbie Mainoo, who's just the man of the moment, resulting in a 2-2 draw against their old foes, Manchester United. So despite dominating the majority of the game, certainly from a possession perspective, Liverpool needed a late penalty from Mohamed Salah to salvage the point. So this draw leaves Liverpool behind Premier League leaders at the moment, Arsenal, but just on goal difference. And then just 1 point ahead of Man City in what promises to be one of the most tightly contested title races we've seen in years. Now let's turn to rugby, left scratching our heads and wondering what went wrong. Holders La Rochelle secured their place in the quarterfinals of the Champions Cup with a hard fought. They had lost to the Stormers in a previous pool stage meeting, but they certainly showed a turnaround now and a lot of guts. Meanwhile, the Bulls, they advanced to the quarterfinals after a dominant 59-19 win against Lyon. They'll face Northampton Saints in the next round as a result. And also mixed feelings about Sevens rugby at the moment. The Blitzboks had a disappointing finish again, this time at the Hong Kong Sevens series, settling for sixth place after a loss to our old foes Fiji in the fifth place playoff. So Fiji claimed a fifth place with a convincing 33-14 dominance over the Blitzboks, and we don't see that very often. Despite the setback, the Springboks Sevens showed some improvement compared to their 11th place finish in the previous tournament in Los Angeles. So next up, the Blitzboks will refocus on to Singapore. And that's on the 3rd to the 5th of May. Then we turn to Formula One and triple world champion Max Verstappen. He secured a commanding victory at the Japanese Grand Prix, leading his teammate Sergio Perez to a dominant 1-2 finish for Red Bull. This team is unstoppable. So Verstappen, starting from pole position, controlled the race from start to finish, claiming his third win of the season, and he finishes 12.535 seconds ahead of Perez, and then Ferrari's Carlos Sainz taking third place just to keep his name in the hat. But that's where we leave our sports results. Of course, we'll chew on all of the sporting gristle as we progress throughout this morning. But right now, of course, we've got some major gristle to chew on, and that's in the form of the weather.
Yes, thank you so much, G-Man. I know a lot of you looking forward to this report right now. Let's see how we can serve you. Now, the SA Weather Service has issued severe warnings for the Western Cape. An orange level 9 alert forecasts disruptive rain, leading to widespread flooding, endangering lives, causing property damage and affecting transport in the Overberg and Southern Cape winelands. Now, the city of Cape Town and the Swartland and Witzenberg municipalities face an orange level 6 warning for potential road and bridge damage. And an orange level 6 alert warns of severe thunderstorms in parts of the Eastern Cape, the Northern Cape, the Northwest and the Free State, causing flooding and severe disruptions. Now, on top of this, a yellow level 4 warning for sea navigation difficulties extends from Sultana Bay to Plettenberg Bay. And moreover, a yellow level 2 warning is out for Gauteng due to thunderstorms and localized flooding. Now, lastly, residents in the northern parts of the Eastern Cape should prepare for heavy rain, flooding, strong winds, and especially cold temperatures. Well, a reminder to all of us to obviously stay safe in these conditions, and we're definitely looking forward to those sunrise views, and we're reminded to send that through to 0634088863 in the next hour. Hopefully we can showcase something spectacular. But for now, though, let's see how we can serve you by taking a look at your temperatures that you can expect on your side of town.
So the weather is what it is today. Just be careful out there. I know certain roads are being closed, certain schools being closed today. So just stay connected to the news airwaves today and just keep abreast of what's going on in your part of the world. Crazy, crazy weather. So we'll do what we can to keep you indoors this morning. We, as I've said a few times, need to chew on some gristle this morning. Of course, the sporting action honed in on some brilliant rugby and, of course, not the best rugby from a South African perspective. We'll delve into that in just a moment. But what I want you to really hone in on right now is the opportunity to start your week on the best possible note by playing the Daily Lotto for an estimated 480,000 Rand. That's our jackpot today. So if you want to make every day feel like a payday, then you need to actually play. And it couldn't be easier to do it. Luckily, there are a host of ways that you can get your hands on your tickets. You can start in store. You can go nationallottery.co.za online. You can use the mobile app, which is brilliant. You can also use your banking app. You can go through the old school star 120 star 7529 hash for all the USSD. And all of those details we'll keep up on our social media platforms. So you've got no excuses. Come on, 480,000 Rand in today's estimated daily jackpot, and it could be yours, but you've got to play now to find out. All the best of luck with that. So we'll be finding out in just a moment who's in, who's out of the Champions Cup. Of course, a bit of mixed feelings about our performances over the weekend when it comes to the sport. And then Ryle is going to be putting his money where his mouth is. We know he can pretty much play any sport at any level. Let's see how he does with a little rugger-inspired workout this morning. We'll be connecting with Robbie and Ryle after this. It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back, you beauties. Yes, mixed feelings about all of the sporting results. I know English Premier League just getting too stressful, so we're not going to talk about that. We're going to hone in on the Champions Cup, a little bit of rugby. And, of course, the defending champions, La Rochelle, proved why they have those credentials, narrowly securing their spot in the quarterfinals after a gripping 22-21 victory over the Stormers here in Cape Town. While the Bulls, well, they just steamrolled right on through. They orchestrated a commanding 59-19 win against Lyon, showcasing some formidable strength at just the right time of the tournament. Now to chat about the weekend's matches is sports podcaster Robbie Gillette. Buddy, I loved I love the fact that you were connected to us and we were connected to you over the weekend, because you had a lot of conversations going online over this weekend, people just losing their minds about the rugby, and rightly so. So let's start with the positive side of that conversation and the absolute steamrolling. I mean, we knew the Bulls would be strong. We knew Leon would struggle. Wow, that was a performance.
It was. I got it wrong. I called it to be a little bit tighter than it was. But I think the Bulls blew them away. First 20 minutes, or first, I think, 13 minutes that scored, and then 22 minutes and like 14-0 up. It's tough to come back, you know, get into the game, 14 points.
Brand of rugby is so secure, still so physical, which we love, which is the South African brand. Yeah. And I think I have a feeling when it comes to the URC and Champions Cup, we've been paid to play that South African brand of rugby. That's what the fans want to see.
For sure.
But the fact that they can balance that now with so much, granted, they've got the pace out wide, they've got the right kind of connections. What makes you most excited about the way that Bulls team came together?
Ooh, I really like, as you say, that physicality they have. They bring that and they marry.
This line has shifted up, which is amazing. So we love that for South African rugby. What we don't like is losing by 1 point to a French side on home soil.
And we've not really experienced that, losing by 1 point, usually winning by 1 point.
Exactly, every single time, literally. It's a difficult one. We want to say, yeah, Monty, you've got to knock those over at those critical moments. But there had been so many penalties and so many faults in that latter stage of that second half. Kick.
Yeah.
It's at those critical moments. For John Dobson, I think at one point there were three knocked out players, like literally major injury concerns. I mean, if he had actually won this one, he would have been left scratching his head thinking, like, who's he going to take to the next phase? But what does this mean for Dobbo, the United Rugby Championship? Is it maybe better to have just one battlefront to focus on from now on? How do you feel about the bigger picture?
No, it's interesting. That was actually sort of the conversation afterwards. It's like, imagine going overseas now to Dublin to play Leinster, and you've got five injuries,
your core, big names.
You're going over there. I think I also want to make mention to Will Skelton of how he protected Salman Murat. Quite impressive. He's a big human being as well.
He is a monster and a gentle giant. Like, you can see the fire in his eyes. But there was at one point where I think one of our players was getting ready to go in for a bit of a rumble, and he just hugged him, man. He just gave him the old bear hug, bro. And you could just see it was not going anywhere, man. But I can understand why Damian Willemse was really touting him beforehand to be that impact player.
Yeah.
Because he's everywhere. He's big enough to be everywhere, literally, at the same time.
He moves so much. He moves around. He gets around the park. He's such a big guy. I mean, we were saying, Evan Roos is a big dude.
Yeah.
You watch him in the line out, and there's Will Skelton.
I think he might have been cradling Evan Roos in his arms.
It's like me next to Evan.
Exactly.
It doesn't make sense.
I'm pretty sure every time I see Evan, he does that to me as well, just because he knows I like it, man. So we're out. Okay, we've got the Bulls are pretty much the lone Rangers in the competition, but they look like they can take it all the way.
For sure. I guess this is about managing those players. They travel now, I think, to Northampton. And Northampton's are a good side.
Yeah.
They're having a good premiership.
Gritty, yeah.
I don't know, sort of a blessing and a curse. Do you want to be in both competitions at this stage of both competitions, or do you want to maybe focus on one? No one ever really wants to lose, you know.
What do you think Jake would say? Bring it on.
Bring it on. He's locked in. I reckon the Bulls are locked in for both.
I'm going to leave you with about 20 seconds. What's going on with the sevens, man? What's happening with the Blitzbox? Don't worry, we'll need a full month to unpack that one. We, of course, focusing on the Rugby Championship, on some champagne rugby in moments. The Stormers really putting their hand up, but ultimately going down to the defending champions, who look pretty good to go after the treble now. But the Bulls, sublime, certainly putting their hands up in a very big way, playing that beautiful game of rugby, South African style, not winning by 1 point, winning by many. We'll take it. Robbie, you're an absolute gem, buddy. Thank you so much for your input. You can let us know how you are feeling about all of this weekend sporting action, especially Liverpool's draw, because 1 point man over there has got mixed feelings about the footy at the moment, so he's going to play rugby instead.
We're not going to talk about the footy. Let's get down into the thing of we're talking about Ruggers, of course. We're talking about something that is perfect for not only the premium rugby players we were talking about now, but when G-Man suggested that we need a solution to the sevens, I say let's look to our youth. Yes, and let's get ready to tackle your fitness goals head on with our rugby-inspired workout. Now, this is going to incorporate dynamic movements. You need strength-building exercises. There's agility drills. And I think this high-energy session is going to push us to our limits. And if you join us, it's going to leave you feeling like bracket champion too, both on and off the field. So joining us, as I said, we've got a look to the youth. We've got Farid Williams in the building, the under 18 rugby captain from Primrose Rugby Club. So let's welcome him to a Feel Good Breakfast Show. Yes, brother. How you doing?
I'm good, and you?
Lekker, man. I'm excited for this one. I know that you're coming here guns blazing. You've got the whole of Primrose name behind you. So what exercises have you got for us? And also, I love the fact that you're making this inclusive. It doesn't look like there's any traditional gym equipment here, so anybody can do this, right?
Yes, anyone in the home can do this. With any equipment, you just have a chair here, so that's basically it.
All right, lekker stuff. Farid, you're an under 18 captain. You know what you're talking about. So I'm going to let you take over the ship from here. Steer us away into getting jacked up for Ruggers. What exercises have you got?
So we're going to start off with just basic push-ups. So the push-ups works your shoulders, works your core, so you're engaging your core through every workout.
Okay, so especially in the push-ups, make sure our core is engaged. Yes. Right, let's drop down. How many reps are we going to go for?
We're only going to go for 8 reps.
8 reps, okay. And like you said, make sure our core is engaged, and we're going to go straight into it.
Yes.
All right, you're going to count us down.
One.
Nice.
Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight.
All right, now that's quite an effective movement, not just for getting some beautifully designed picks on you, but I think at the same time it's quite practical in rugby that you're often pushing away your defenders, your attackers, or trying to break through a maul, so you need that pushing strength.
Yes,
right?
Defending off and for the tackling, you need a lot of push up.
Makes sense. So practicing this is definitely going to roll over to the field. What else you got for us?
So you got some incline push ups with the chair.
Ooh, interesting stuff. All right. So incline push ups, just using a basic chair, I guess. Anything that you have at home that's stable that you can put your hands on to create an incline will work, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So let's do this. How are we gripping it? Anything specific?
No.
Just on the edge of the chair.
And going for 10 reps.
10 reps. All right. Stepping this one up. All right. Now, I know you mentioned 8 reps in the previous exercise. This one, you're mentioning 10 reps. For the entire workout, do we just go with one exercise, or do we go for a couple sets of each exercise?
We can go for a couple sets, or we can do each workout and then do it again.
Ooh, okay, nice. So go through the entire round, and then you complete like maybe 3 rounds?
Yes.
Okay, I like that. And for you as a rugby player, obviously you're juggling both playing rugby and training, exercising like this. Yes. How often do you exercise and do these workouts versus working out on the field?
So these workouts you can do every night before you go to bed, or in the morning when you wake up. And then on the field, we 3 times a week and we play on a Saturday.
All makes sense for an under 18 to look like a giant like this. So Jack, clearly he's doing something right. So I'm going to pay attention and carry on doing these workouts.
Okay,
what other exercises you got?
We're going to go into the core exercises and then do mountain climbers first.
Why is core so important for athletes?
So for core, it's your base for everything.
Yeah.
So in your tackling, in your running, you need the core workouts to just have that base fitness.
Stick around. This is a smart man, you people. All right, how are we doing this?
So we're going to go into the plank position.
Okay.
And we're going to go 5 reps on each side, alternating.
Alternating, okay.
Keeping your core engaged the whole time.
Ooh, okay, I see there. Yeah, it gets that like deep contraction in the core as well. And I like the fact that you're controlling this one, because often a lot of people just run through this with speed, and that takes away the quality that you can really get from stimulating that abdominal region. So, man, it's coming through with the good stuff here. Primrose will be proud of you, my man.
And now we can switch to the spider where you go. You step out.
The spider? Oh, okay, you make it a little bit wider. All right, let me just move my chair out the way, yeah? Like this one. All right, so stepping out wider now, right?
Yes, 5 on each side.
Go wide, like that?
Yeah.
Nice, okay. And we're going for 5 on each side. Mzansi, just a reminder, you can join us with this workout. You can replicate this workout as well, especially if you're trying to work on your fitness, on your rugby game. And this is something that's going to add to the arsenal. And let me tell you, I am feeling that the core is burning, bro. Woo. Simple, yet so effective. Thank you so much for coming through, man. That's how you light up the stage. That's how you light up the field, clearly, and how you become a captain. So any advice? I know you are a youngster. You've still got an incredible career ahead of you. But for any of the youngsters watching you right now that are probably more than inspired by what you've just done, what advice do you have for them that are trying to achieve their goals in sport?
I think that you can't rely on motivation. You have to rely on your discipline and your consistency every single day to achieve what you want.
Bars of gold. Thank you so much for coming through, Mzansi. I hope you enjoyed this session. I hope you've been inspired. Our youth are going to keep doing that right throughout this morning, so you better stick around. And from our under 18 Primrose captain, I want to say thank you, my friend. Good luck for the rest of the season. You're going to smash it. And hopefully see you soon, man. I think big things to come.
Thank you so much.
Lekker stuff. Mzansi, hope you enjoyed that one. Ooh, I'm feeling pumped. I'm ready for Monday. And I think you are too. Let's go!
Oh, we love that sort of pump, my friend. I know you were inviting us all to join you for that workout, but we shall not, okay, because you've done it for us. Thank you, buddy. We're going to continue to inspire you with incredible young people. We've got young Alex Stevens, a figure skater who is doing very big things, and she is wee small. She is such a dynamic young athlete, and she's going to get us inspired to start our own journey. I have a feeling then one of my favorites, Nick Hammond, is back to chat about the coolest ever competition for schools to get behind. Yep, that's him doing his war cry. Look at that. It's been mind-blowing to see the geus in South African schools. If you thought you understood rivalry, you don't. We'll introduce you to this incredible campaign after this.
Are you auditioning and getting ready for Tropica Island of Treasure? Well, don't let joint and muscular pain hold you back. DeepEat is your go-to warm-up solution and SA's number one choice.
Oh, yes, and here's an extra incentive. The top seven contestants heading to the island will each receive 10,000 Rand from DeepEat. And remember, you can upload your audition with the hashtag DeepEat and the hashtag Tropica and tag my Tropica.
Who knows, you could be competing in Zanzibar.
Yeah, it's time to reach your full potential.
Get DeepEat and conquer the island.
Welcome back. We promised you inspiration on your feel-good breakfast show, and we have got it in spades, and we're going to continue on that trend right now with young Alex Stevens. She is a very, and I say it with all due respect, but she's just getting started in life, a figure skater from Cape Town who is making a big mark in this world. Alex's journey began at a very young age when she was inspired by her sister's graceful moves on the ice, and from winning bronze medals to competing internationally and getting her national colours, Alex's determination and hard work have certainly led to her achieving remarkable milestones in such a short time in the skating world. And joining us today is young Alex Stevens and her very proud mom, Simone. Thank you so much for being here. Can we give them a feel-good welcome on a Monday morning? Because, I'm sorry, I wish we had a live studio audience and not just my poor cameraman having to clap every time, but you're worthy of applause. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being here. Why? Why figure skating? Because looking at you move on the ice, looking at some of the YouTube videos, you're good. You are really, really good. I would imagine you could have gone into a number of different sports. It was your sister that inspired you in this case. Yes. Why? What was magical about skating that drew you in?
Well, long time ago, she had a birthday party at the ice rink, and she saw how cool it was for the others to glide upon the ice, so she started taking lessons. And then I thought it was cool to like skate on frozen water.
It is
so cool. I joined.
And then the rest, yeah, you can see. What about it do you love? Is it a freedom thing? Because you look so graceful and just so effortless when you're out there. What's the best part?
I love jumping.
Making me nervous. Aren't you nervous, Mom? I mean, we've spent time on the ice. Can you actually ice skate?
No.
Exactly. So are you not terrified seeing your little girl do these amazing, crazy things on ice? How do you feel about this incredible career that's started at such a young age?
Yeah, I mean, she had a number of things, like you said, that she could possibly choose from. And she chose figure skating. And I mean, with the amazing coaches that they have at the ice rink, I mean, the Western Province Association with you know, together with SAFSA, they have amazing coaches and we trust them, and we see the results and you're like, wow, is that my daughter out there actually doing those spins and those jumps and the choreography that they have to learn?
Because it's a mixed art, this. There is an artistic element to it where you are dancing effectively on ice, which
exactly,
is why
yeah.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
Yet there is a level of technicality and physicality that is just off the charts in that sense. So it's quite a crazy thing to know that you can't teach her to do this. You've got to kind of hand her over to these structures, to these mentors around. When you start to see this being unlocked, how does that feel as a parent?
It's proud moments. And you think to yourself, can she actually achieve what they're asking for? But I mean, after so many lessons, and like I said, it's a trust process that she has to do with the coaches and vice versa. And the achievements, it's like, it's amazing. And as a parent, you sit there and you think, wow.
What's wrong with me? Why couldn't I do this at some point? I will show you me on ice someday. And they record me on ice all the time, just for humorous value generally. Why are you not scared? How are you not terrified when you do these things? What do you say to yourself in your head when you've got to do the bigger jumps, when you've got to do the more complicated stuff? How do you keep so calm and cool? Or are you terrified?
Now and then I am terrified. But if I just work on it, then I know I can get it. Because I've done everything before, so I know I can do it again.
That is crazy. I mean, there are adult sportsmen and women that haven't got that right yet, to be able to wrap the mental game around it. She is still so young, and I say that with all due respect. There are so many different paths laying out in front of her.
Yeah.
Where do we take this? Do you make it that big thing and say, okay, well, if she's got her national colours now, she's a professional sportswoman, she's going to do this for the rest of her life? Or do you still keep an open field? How do you as a parent approach talent like this?
No, we definitely keep it as an open field, but she's still young.
Yeah.
And I mean, things change all the time. So, I mean, she does a variety of different extramural activities. I mean, she dances with the Rhythm Factory as well. So we keep an open field, but we support her all the way. So whatever journey, and I mean, she's very active. So one day it's here, one day it's there. She's all over the show. And I think as parents, it's just for us to support her and let her follow her dream. And, you know, just be there every step of the way. Because, you have to keep them in check. You know, are you happy? Are you enjoying it? Because that's the important factor. You have to enjoy your sport. So if she enjoys it and she loves it, we support her. We beside her, behind her all the way.
Alex, when you think about your future, and it's a different world that you're going to inherit, you're going to be able to do so many things that we can't even dream of yet. What do you want to be when you grow up?
I might want to be, it's like a choreographer, it's a dance choreographer, but for figure skating.
Oh, I love that. Do you think that your dancing and the ability, your musicality, gives you an edge in the figure skating?
Possibly, but they're very different.
How so?
Opposite.
Really? How
like
so?
The ones like straight and like your posture must be good, and then the next one will be like loose and baggy
free
stuff.
Yeah, I love that. That's called balance in this life. That is called balance. Mm-hmm. When you talk about balance, it's when you've got someone who can just attack life like this.
Mm.
How do you channel that energy in the right way? What sort of conversations do you guys have about where her headspace is?
Well, I mean, at this point, we'll have all types of conversations because she's still young, like I said. So we need to understand where she's at. And whatever she talks about in terms, whether it's figure skating, we will channel that. And I mean, recently she attended, for example, a competition in Slovenia representing the country. So, I mean, that few weeks before that, it wasn't even a consideration. But the minute she said that and the coach says, right, we're going.
Lock it in, baby.
We locked it in.
supported
her.
I love that. And that's all you can do. You've just got to be there to support. Advice for another young figure skater or a young athlete wanting to kind of level up like you've leveled up. What's been your secret? What advice do you have for them?
Just don't give up. Go for your dreams.
Do it. Just there's fire in those eyes. I love it. We are so inspired by the potential of young South Africans right now. It just feels like we've got a new era emerging and so much talent, yes. But what I'm loving the most is the mindset, how amazing these young people are and the energy that they have. We are here to be inspired by that. So to both of you, thank you so much. I look forward. I'm going to be interviewing you probably for the rest of your life. and that's the nature of this game. But what a pleasure to be plugging into this kind of talent, just starting this incredible journey.
Thanks, Graham.
Thank you.
I absolutely love these conversations because if you think about it, these are faces that you're seeing for the first time that you're probably going to see for many more times after this. As we invest in their future, they invest in it too, and we know it's going to be incredible. Now, speaking of incredible, we had an incredible question for you this morning, which I absolutely loved. It was about a rule that we'd love to make and possibly even a law to ensure people had a better work-life balance. Now, we wanted to know from you what that rule or law would be, and we wanted you to share your thoughts and come through with some voice notes come through on our our WhatsApp line and, of course, the social media channels. And our number was 0634-088-863. So a reminder to you, Mzanzi, to come through, share those answers with us. But we've got some to share already. We've got Zelda Dalkos, who says, people with children work half day so they can pick the children up after school. Ooh, I like that work-life balance. That's a great one. And I think many people would love the company they work for when they did that. We've got Max Rintia Wilson Dalport, who says, more salary, less tax. I don't see how tax improves anyone or anything. Oh, okay. A statement has been made, people. I love this. Now we keep it coming. We've got Firoda David saying, good morning, a four-day work week. I've seen this happen overseas and I've heard it's been working exceptionally well. I'm going to jump on the bandwagon. I like that. Rishi also says, good morning. Just sending some love. Have a wonderful day. Well, have a wonderful day to you too as well, Rishi. And yeah, thank you so much, Mzanzi, for sharing these comments. We're going to keep it coming through all throughout this morning. And hopefully we get some more rules and some more laws that we can share with you, and maybe something that possibly you could adopt right now. Maybe give your CEO a new idea. Listen, we've got some more X comments that we want to share with you after Facebook. This one's from Mercy saying, good morning. What are you supposed to do? Nothing more or less. Do what you paid to do. All right, so a little bit of an opinion on our good morning post there. Not really an answer, but it's fine. I'll take it. I'm here for it. And then Mtandeni says, good morning. I'm sure it's every Monday. They must not work over themselves. So maybe are you trying to say like don't work too hard on a Monday? Maybe you do like a half day Monday or something like that? If that's the idea, then you got my vote. I'm standing behind you. Now, listen, Mzanzi, we've got a lot to look forward to. So I want you to stand behind us for the next few hours, because there is everything from diving into the kitchen and making some cheesy pockets to meeting with our family. Someone that's doing the most, getting some power from the youngsters. There's this five-drive Warcry Championships, and this man over here is the host, bringing us the champions.
What's
how
up,
you
brother?
Doing, bro?
Good. How are you?
Oh, it's so good to see you in real life. We're always chatting on the socials. I'm dying to find out more about this man, and I know you are too, Mzanzi. So what? He's dressed up looking suave for the occasion, and we're going to dive into this man's incredible journey. There's war cries coming through, and we've got to crown a champion in just a bit. Don't go anywhere. It's my feel-good breakfast show. Oh, yes, Mzanzi, welcome back. It's your feel-good breakfast show. It's Monday, and we're going to turn things up a bit. Let's bring some spirit to this conversation. Now, listen, South Africa stands out as, let's be honest, a truly stunning destination, to say the least, and that's on the global map, right? Now, one of the things that truly sets us apart is our incredible spirit, perfectly showcased by the energetic high school war cries we are known for. Now, this year, Nick Hammond from 5FM went looking for the best high school war cry in the country. And I believe that they found it at St. Stithian's Girls College. Let's take a look.
ride with the mob. Hum, voila, check with the team. Team, do your job. Same as the name, we're bringing the A-Day. Others can watch, but they know they ain't the same.
Ride with the mob.
Bro, I'm pumped. Let's go do something crazy right
Let's
now.
Let's do it, man. You and me. Let's go jump off something.
Nick, how you doing, bro?
Good. It's great to see you, Raul. Yeah,
you
happy,
too,
excited.
Man. Before we even get into this incredibleness, I think the last time I chatted to you, I didn't even get to speak to you up until you were recently married, man. It's been like 5 months since then.
Congratulations to me.
What's the married life been like for you?
It's been amazing. Somewhere behind the set, my wife is hanging out with me because I now insist that she comes wherever I go.
Oh, nice.
As often as possible, we travel together. No, it's been amazing. 6 months now. Got married in Dalstrom, which was one of the most beautiful parts of the country to have got married. We had our owl deliver our rings. Went to Mozambique
an
for the
owl,
honeymoon. Yes.
Like Harry Potter owl.
Yes, 100%.
No
like
ways,
that. Yeah,
bro.
It was a trained owl from a conservation site that went through a forest and delivered our rings. Thank goodness. Here they are.
Okay, well, the bar was clearly set there, and you've just been doing incredible things since, man. And speaking of this, I love seeing how you're getting schools to really be proud and stand behind their war cries. It's something that I think we can all have some form of a nostalgic memory from, especially if we did have the opportunity to go to school. But talk to me about this. What makes a powerful war cry? What is that, like, real umami behind it? And why was this discovery so important for you?
I'm glad you said the word proud, because it's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, globally, South Africans are recognized for their high school war cries.
Yeah.
So all over the world, people get really fascinated and excited by what it is that we seem to have. And in a word, it's chiz, right? It's a very particular kind of spirit that exists in South Africa, best exemplified by high schools. And we wanted to find out, not necessarily like who the best of the best is, but if we could create an opportunity for schools to be able to shine on a global stage through 5FM. And that's exactly what we did.
So you did that. You started the 5 Drive War Cry Championships for 2024, hopefully the first of many, but it seems like. Well, how did it go?
Went incredibly. Yeah. It exceeded our expectations. I mean, South Africans and the globe came through and voted for their favorite schools and showed support. We had everyone from ASAP Ferg to Queen Latifah to Sharon Stone to Bert Kaeschner sharing the content, engaging with the content.
That's insane.
Millions and millions of views across TikTok and Instagram. Huge supports on 5FM on radio. It blew our minds and exceeded our expectations. But I think it's because people really love war cries. We're a national station. It's the perfect fit, right?
Yeah, and look, I mean, that's firstly incredible because that's like a global stamp of approval for our young talent here, which is insane for me. But on top of that, I think it speaks more to like the quality that we have. I mean, how do you determine amongst all these entries who's going to make, let's say, the top 4 or the top 5, an example? And looking at the results here, the top 4 were all single-sex schools. So what do you think the reason is behind, firstly, figuring out how to get to this top 4 and what makes them stand out from the rest? Because we're talking about premium talent here.
So what we did is we had a panel of judges, different people who were brought in with a very strict rubric that they had to vote on. And in that was everything from, you know, unity and the presentation to the, obviously, you know, we looked at social media and things like that. But funny enough, that was a very, very small component of what ultimately made this up.
Yeah.
So people voted and scores were issued. And that's how we determined who eventually were the top 10, the top 5, 4, and eventually the top 1. And what you said about same-sex schools is really interesting. So I want to put a call out to co-ed schools in South Africa to enter more the next time that we do this. And potentially we could have a co-ed victory next time.
And I think there's a massive advantage there. I mean, you can hit all the octaves now. You've got the whole range. Listen, this is insane. I love what you've done. And I wanted to ask, did you get an opportunity to like present the winners? Like, was it a live presentation? Did you go to St. Stithian School, Girls College, and actually do that?
This worked out really well. So we wanted to coincide this with the Easter period in South Africa because so many different schools are having celebrations and festivals, like sporting festivals. And so when we'd found out that St. Stithian's Girls College were the ones that had won, we decided to rock up there in the morning, get the school together, and tell them that I wanted to address all of the finalist schools. So I stood in front of them for about 5 minutes, making them feel as though I was there to tell them they'd lost, which I just couldn't help doing. And then eventually, at the very end, I said, listen, I've got something very special to tell you. You are the winners of the first of its kind ever five-drive war cry championship.
Oh.
And they just erupted, went straight into doing another war cry. It was a spiritual experience. It was wonderful.
Man, and you can see the sass, you can see the energy, you can see the pride here. Wow, I look forward to so much more of this, especially just whenever you are touching something, it seems to be so relevant, so raw, so real, and it's resonating with South Africa so perfectly. I know that I'm pretty sure I'm going to see more of this in time to come, but what else can we expect from Nick Hammond in the future? I know you're still diving into the world of food. I'm loving this exploration you're taking us on, man. But what else can we expect from you this year? Anything crazy?
I appreciate that. Thank you. The food journey has been amazing. I mean, I've always been into travel and that kind of content, and there have been some really exceptional opportunities that have opened up doors for me since trying to do this all on TikTok and Instagram and all that. There's a television show in the works that I can share with you, I think, relatively exclusively. On top of that, we've got huge plans for Five Drive this year. We're going to continue to travel the country in search of the people, places, hidden gems, everything that makes it great. We'd love to come back down and see you guys when that happens.
Yes, please.
But I'm just excited about enjoying married life and spending time with, you know, my wife and my two dogs and getting in the kitchen and just kind of like, you know, enjoying this period of life a little bit. I'm in my 30s now, so things are slowly but surely starting to settle down somewhat.
The puzzle pieces are coming together. You're laying down some roots, but at the same time, you've got to juggle this space you play in, and you're doing it so perfectly. So kudos to you, man. I love seeing everything that you do, and I want to just encourage you to keep it coming. We love it. Mzansi loves it as well. And I want to thank you for sharing your time, not only just for you, but also bringing your wife through to the studio as well. I know you can't officially say hi to her, but I'm glad that you guys are sharing your energy with us.
She's happy. You guys make good coffee.
Well, from good coffee, a good conversation, we head to the kitchen and hopefully we can tick the box when it comes to good food. Check it out.
How do you make pizza better? That's a big question. It's an important question, I'll tell you. You make it into a pizza pocket and you add more cheese. And today's recipe is specifically for the kids, both grown up and still little. We're obviously going to make a few more so that mom and dad can also enjoy along with us. And we are making extra cheesy pizza pockets. So simple to make, but I just need another big kid to come and join me. Thank you. Well, you got the brief. Yet. You can, actually. You're allowed to act like a four-year-old, which is why I'm going to give you the big knife. Okay, now I'm still not trusted to use the big chef's knives, so we had to bring in the professionals, okay? So, buddy, are you a pizza fan?
Showing them that I'm missing a finger.
Exactly, I know. And they are always sharper than I think. Are you that guy?
Pizza fan in the world, yes.
What is your general pizza go-to flavor?
Oh, man, I like... I'm quite an indulgent pizza eater. Ooh, but if I had to pick a favorite, I would say like a pepperoni.
Oh, really?
Well, a salty pepperoni.
See how good this guy is at his job, really? He was scanning the table long enough to see what was on it, and then that became his favorite because he's just so awesome, man. So, buddy, we're making the cutest little pizza pockets with the aim of the kids being able to play along. And but I can tell you now, from the coal face of trying to get my kids to eat, okay, if you can get them mutually invested in the outcome, it makes all the difference. When you can get hands-on like this, even better. So are you up to the challenge, my friend? You're going to be cutting our pastry,
okay.
All right? So we need as many pizza little squares as we can get out of this. So I reckon if you cut one down the middle,
yes,
and then maybe we can get four or five cross sections, but basically we're going to be taking these little squares or these rectangles and folding them into triangles. So maybe let's try for four so we can load them extra full
of
our ingredients. And we are using our salami, which is obviously kind of tantamount to a pepperoni. Perfect. Look at you. Oh, they call him the mad genius. He can actually cut perfect squares without even measuring them. Does that make you a mad genius or just mad?
Both.
Both. A bit of both. Okay, that is perfect. Even our foodies upstairs are going, wow, that is perfect. They've done the protractor. They've worked it out. Absolutely brilliant. So we're going to start with one. Let's put this little guy over here. And then you can grab one as well and come sidle up and next to me. And this is where the fun begins. Okay. So we've got our cheese and we've got our clover cheese here nicely rolled up for a perfect little pocket. And we've got our salami and a little bit of tomato. You are allowed. You are allowed. So what we need to do is think of the cement around that's going to kind of bind. So we want to take just a little bit of our tomato. And the main thing is on the edges there. I would probably be kind of too liberal with the tomato because that's the kind of guy I am. I'm always like more than less.
You've got a lot more than you, is that
Yeah, I know, man, but that's, you're a big guy. You're a big guy.
It's going to be all right.
All right, okay, and that folds perfectly because you have cut perfect squares, okay? Then we're going to take, what do you think first? I'm going to go a bit of cheese.
Okay, let's have some more cheese.
That Pop it good. There, yeah. Are we going to have any left for the pocket? Probably not, but it's okay. And then I'm thinking, seeing as they gave us so much salami, let's pop two of those guys in there.
Okay.
And then we're going to fold this little puppy over. Okay. Into a pocket.
Oh, like I see. That. Okay.
And then you've got a fork there, my friend.
Yeah.
Can you grab that fork? And then we're just going to push down our sides, and we're going to start on another one.
Oh, I see why you didn't put as much tomato sauce as me.
Because I'm not a mad genius, man. No, just wait, bro. You don't know. You don't know the results. You don't know what this is going to turn out like. You might have discovered an entirely new dish. There might be an Italian watching us right now going, what the hell are you doing? No, there probably is an Italian watching us right now, just rolling and rolling. That was artistic. It was beautiful. Hey?
Yeah.
Look at that. I love it, man. And then you've got yourself your own cheesy pocket that is, of course, jam-packed with cheese. Now, for this particular recipe, we are going to obviously go the convenient route using our Clover's individually wrapped cheeses, which does make it really, really simple. You know, slicing needed, no dicing required, which really does help when you're working with the little ones, especially if you're going to get them to help out with critical phases. And then Clover's individually wrapped cheese slices also come in cheddar and gouda, so you can now add both if you like. I'll put more in. Put like five cheeses in there. Pack in as much flavor as possible and then feel free to add whatever toppings of your choice. What else would you squeeze in there? Maybe for the grown-up version, a jalapeno. Oh,
some spice would definitely be amazing. Mm. I'm going to dip it in more sauce as well when I take it out.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Do you remember we used to get from a particular company breadsticks that you could kind of dip into the sauce for like R7?
I'm well aware of every type of carb.
Exactly. Carbs on carbs. Okay, well, now we've done one. Let's do another one, seeing as we can. And we're going to pop these guys onto our baking tray. They go into the oven. 15 minutes, 180, but just keep an eye on them. Oh, wait, we need some egg wash. Absolutely right. Before we forget, man, we forget, we want that beautiful crispiness. You aren't the genius I thought you were, man. unless you just didn't want to show me up to be a bit of a...
No.
Oh, yeah, there we go. I'm going to put on yours.
Great,
how's that?
Perfect.
Okay, lovely. All right, and then see, we've got a sweet chili dipping sauce as well, which is quite crazy. Okay, so we're going to pop these guys on. Go for it, my friend. You can start working on your next pizza slice. And this is a jumping off point. This is an opportunity for you to have a little bit of fun. You can make them en masse. You can make little bits for your kids to enjoy. You can make them just before lunch and they can get stuck in. You can pre-make them and pop them in the fridge and then kind of cook them off just before lunch. I love the fact that you're going to have the smell of fresh pizza in your house. It's simple, it's easy. And, hey, couldn't be more delicious.
This is really good. And it's not even cooked yet.
Absolutely amazing. All right, buddy, I'm going to let you, seeing as you've worked so hard in the kitchen, and I'm hoping these have cooled down. Yeah, I think they are ready to taste. Are you up for a taste of the final product?
I'd love to.
Because you've earned that, right? This is your breakfast. Okay. Can you review it like you do on the IG?
Can we do one of these proper? I'm looking for the best type thing.
Okay, now we want a professional review here, please. Okay.
You're welcome. Oh, man.
Huh?
The cheese in particular is really good when it's melted, man.
You see?
That's delicious, yeah. I know this is like, you know, technically for other people too.
No, it's yours. It's all yours, man.
I'm going to finish it if it's okay.
Because you have managed to activate Gies through the entire country, okay? You deserve this, my friend.
I appreciate that common thread.
You are getting people out of bed this morning, going to school with this notion that their school could be the best, the proudest in the world.
Yes.
Now, you've tapped into something absolutely amazing with
this. Awesome, thank you.
So I'm hoping that when you start that phase of your other journey, and when you're going to cook for your kids, you can come back here and we can give you some more tips. Buddy, you are amazing at what you do. Thank you so much for bringing that here to the whole country, dude.
Ah, man.
We absolutely love it. Any last bit of advice for those that are still in the running?
I think that, because we'd said this unapologetically, we're going to now move to regionals. I think put your effort there. So if you are in the Eastern Cape and the Northern Cape and Limpopo, I think these are the three provinces we heard the least from. you who I want to hear from.
Time to put your hand up. Yeah. You've got it. And we know there are some amazing schools there. So do that. Be inspired. You can inspire your fellow learners with a beautiful meal like this. And most importantly, parents, I hope we've given you something to inspire your kids to enjoy their food just a little bit more. Easy, cheesy. So easy to get the kids involved and get them enjoying these beautiful little pizza pockets over the weekend. And if you want to find this recipe as simple as it is, expressoshow.com is where you'll find it. Enjoy. Let's crack on.
Clover cheese is for those who love life, where everything falls into place and melts away our cares, adding joy and stretching our imagination. Clover cheese, perfectly crafted.
Made with love by Clover.
Ah, the belly has been satisfied and absolutely love catching up with our family. And speaking of catching up, we're going to catch up with us. Myself and G-Man have something to share with you when it comes to our weekend highlights. And obviously, not only that, but we've got a young superstar in the building. We're talking about Liam van Heyder. The man is standing by, ready to share his journey and his exceptional talent with the world. So you, Mzansi, don't need to go anywhere. A lot to look forward to right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. See you after this.
Welcome back, you beauties. 1 hour done and dusted. Two more to savor with you. Let's get this ship sailing and get into those national news and sporting headlines, and then the second hour can commence.
Thank you so much, G-Man. Yes, it's 1 minute before the hour and we're starting with national headlines. Now, the Minister of Police, Becky Cele, says some 500,000 suspects have been arrested nationwide since Operation Shanele was launched in May last year. Now, several breakthroughs have been made in high-profile cases, including 7 suspects that are currently being tried for the murder of musician Kiernan Forbes, known as AKA. And the National Task Force investigating the Fort Hare University murders has so far arrested 24 suspects. Now, moreover, of late, 2 KwaZulu-Natal suspects, aged 33 and 41, have been arrested by the Hawks after allegedly kidnapping 6 people and demanding a ransom. Well, sticking in national headlines, gale force winds in the Western Cape yesterday caused widespread damage, including a trailer blown off a bridge near the Huonot Tunnel on the N1. Now, there were also reports of trees falling on homes and roads and severe traffic congestion. Now, incidents of roofs being ripped off were noted in Somerset West, Macassar, Mitchell's Plain and Clifton, with numerous homes still without power. Now, the Western Cape Premier, Alan Windey, has declared school closures today in the Overberg, Cape Winelands and Helderberg areas due to anticipated heavy rainfall. Now, further updates in our weather report. Well, we now move over to international headlines, and Israel's military said yesterday it was reducing its number of soldiers in southern Gaza. Now, Israel and Hamas have also confirmed yesterday they'd sent delegations to Cairo to join fresh ceasefire negotiations. Now, Qatar's Prime Minister Mohammed bin Abdul Rahman Al Thani will join negotiators from Egypt, Israel and Hamas. Now, yesterday, exactly 6 months ago, Hamas attacks Israel. Some 1,200 people died and more than 250 were taken hostage. Now, about 33,000 Palestinians have died in the war between Hamas and Israel in Gaza since then. Now, next up in our international headlines, Rwanda's President Paul Kagame says the international community, and quotes, failed all of us. Now, this as he marked 30 years since the 1994 genocide that killed some 800,000 people. Now, Kagame was addressing world leaders who had gathered at the Kigali Genocide Memorial in the Rwandan capital to commemorate the bloodshed. Now, Rwanda was completely humbled by the magnitude of our loss, and this being said by Kagame himself. Now, in 1994, extremists from the Hutu ethnic group launched a 100-day killing spree in which members of the Tutsi minority and Hutu moderates were killed. Well, next up in the headlines, making entertainment headlines this morning's the news that the legendary hard rock band Kiss has sold its extensive song catalogue to a Swedish music investor for a staggering sum exceeding 5.62 billion rand. Now, Pophouse Entertainment of Stockholm has acquired not only the music rights, but also the band's brand, likeness and intellectual property. Now, this sale coincides with Kiss's retirement from live performances on their End of the Road World Tour. Now, Pophouse's acquisition extends beyond music, enabling them to create AI-generated content using the Kiss brand. Now, known for their iconic face paint and rock anthems, Kiss was founded in 1973 by Paul Stanley and Gene Simmons, ultimately selling over 100 million records during their illustrious 50-year career. Well, it'll be interesting to see what AI pops up in the time to come. But for now, though, it is that, well, the time has arrived for G-Man to give us all things sport. And here's the latest.
I'm just going to say it, that is terrifying. No AI needed when it comes to the football just yet. Liverpool's Premier League title challenge obviously hindered just a little by goals from Bruno Fernandes and the man of the moment, Kobbie Mainoo, resulting in a 2-2 draw against their old foes, Man United. So despite dominating the majority of the game, Liverpool needed a late penalty from Mohamed Salah to salvage that point at a vital point, as the draw now leaves Liverpool behind their Premier League leading Arsenal foes on goal difference alone, just 1 point ahead of Man City as well in what promises to be one of the most tightly contested title races in years. Then we turn to rugby and holders La Rochelle. They secured their place in the quarterfinals of the Champions Cup with a hard-fought 22-21 victory over the Storm. Turnaround. Well, the Bulls, they march on a dominant 59-19 win against Lyon to kickstart the weekend. And after that win, they will now face the very tough Northampton Saints in the next round. Then we turn to sevens, and still left scratching our heads, really. The Blitzboks had another disappointing finish, this time at the Hong Kong Sevens Series, settling for sixth place after a loss to Fiji in that fifth-place playoff. All unfamiliar territory. So Fiji claiming fifth place with a convincing 33-14 victory over the Blitzboks. We don't see that very often, and despite the setback, the Springboks Sevens, they did show some improvement compared to their 11th-place finish in the previous tournament in Los Angeles. But I don't think it would have been too difficult to do that. Next up, the Blitzboks will have to refocus for Singapore, and that's on from the 3rd to the 5th of May. And then finally, we turn to Formula One and Triple World champion Max Verstappen. He secured a commanding victory at the Japanese Grand Prix yesterday, leading his teammate Sergio Perez to a dominant 1-2 finish for Red Bull, who are dominant at the moment. So Verstappen, starting from pole position, controlled the race from start to finish, claiming his third win of the season in so doing. He finished 12.535 seconds ahead of Perez, with Ferrari's Carlos Sainz taking third place, finishing off the podium. And that's where we leave our sporting news for now. The roads should be waking up in this weather. I'm sure there is a lot to take in and a couple of warnings. Let's get the latest on the traffic front with Ryle before we touch on the weather.
Thank you so much, Jim. And yes, let's dive into all things traffic right now. And starting off in Pretoria, now there's been an accident on the N1 southbound at Atterbury Road. Now, the left lane is affected, as you can see from the visuals, and this is resulting in very slow moving traffic. So if you are passing through, then please do allow for more travel time. We now move over to the Western Cape, and PRASA has broadcasted that the gale force winds in the Western Cape have affected the Stellenbosch Southern Line, including the Cape Flats Line. So the repairs to the damaged overhead electric infrastructure will be done when it is safe to do so, but commuters are advised to please make use of an alternative mode of transport, as again, from the visuals, you can see that things are dramatically affected. We're going to stick to Western Cape right now, and there are multiple road closures due to the adverse weather conditions that you've been hearing about. You can see them on our screen right now, so please make use of any alternative routes. And again, exercise caution if you are driving through or past any of these areas. And our sentiments go out to everybody that is affected by this weather right now. We are just praying and hoping that you can stay safe and buckle up while you are on the roads. For now, though, we get from the roads to the sky, and I'll find out what's happening the latest when it comes to weather. Now, as you can imagine, we have lots of warnings to issue out this morning. Now, the SA Weather Service has issued severe warnings for the Western Cape and an orange level 9 alert forecast disruptive rain leading to widespread flooding, endangering lives, causing property damage and affecting transport in the Overberg and Southern Cape Winelands. Now, the city of Cape Town, the Swartland and the Witzenberg municipalities face an orange level 6 warning for potential road and bridge damage. And on top of this, an orange level 6 alert warns of severe thunderstorms in parts of the Eastern Cape, the Northern Cape, the Northwest and the Free State, causing flooding and severe disruptions. Now, on top of this, a yellow level 4 warning for sea navigation difficulties extends from Saldanha Bay to Plettenberg Bay. And moreover, a yellow level 2 warning is also out for Gauteng, and that's due to thunderstorms and localized flooding. Now, lastly, residents in the northern parts of the Eastern Cape should prepare for heavy rain, flooding, strong winds, and especially cold temperatures. Well, we've definitely given you a warning and hoping and praying that you can stay safe. But from our weather news, we dive into hopefully a motivating part of this session, and that's our sunrise view of the hour. Now, this one was sent in by Joyful, and it's all the way out in Impangeni. And as you can see, it looks like the weather is gloomy. The rain looks like it is coming through as well, and it's definitely fitting of what we are all experiencing in South Africa right now. So thank you for sending something real, and we'll keep it coming in the next hour. The number is 063-408-8863. Please share your sunrise view with us. But for now, though, let's take a gander at the temperatures that you can expect on your side of town.
Of course, with the weather as it has been over this weekend, crazy, crazy stuff. And we can take nothing away from how hectic it's been for many. But we thought, let's take the edge off and just chat and have a little bit of a catch up. I know busy times in all of our lives. So we do like to kind of check in with each other every once in a while and find out what we're up to. And this was a crazy weekend for me, Brad. I've got to say, and there are no photos because I was in kind of rehab mode from about Friday. I think I hit breaking points.
Oh, yeah, the
Went
body?
For like a two-hour session with my doctor of pain to do the deep tissue stuff and kind of rode that wave through the rest of the weekend. But I've got to say,
just like recovering all weekend.
Just trying to make it through, man. With the kids, it's just so full on. But I've got to say to my beautiful kids for pulling me through this weekend and getting my body back. Just thank you. And my gorgeous wife for just putting up with me at any time. but now you've got so much going on in your life at the moment. You're doing such big things, big, beautiful things. Take us through this weekend's weather. How did that affect your
Bro, like, your I'm plans? Still, I'm petrified right now. So we had a great accomplishment with that project I'm working on, which is the gym. We built a roof for the weather, for the rain,
yay,
right? And it's a big roof, and I'm so scared. As you can see from the visuals there, that's about 18 meters by 30 meters, okay? We built that ourselves, bro, like by hand, blood, sweat, and tears over the weekend. And I'm so scared that that thing's not going to be there.
It basically looks like a giant sail.
Don't say those words, because with the weather that's coming in right now, I'm just like, when I go there this afternoon, I'm just praying that it's still there. But the weekend was good. We got to test the roof out and had a class under the covers while the rain did come. The wind hadn't arrived yet, but it was really great. A great atmosphere. We could fit like 16 people under that roof there. This was actually a different visual of me going to watch Mulz at the quarterfinal of the CrossFit Games.
What is going on there? Is she becoming this person?
Bro, she's like, I think she's stronger than me, G.
No,
like,
I know she is.
She's looking so good. Her team is being, they're so powerful. She's put so much work into this. You know, Carl's also been working on it a little bit, so
well,
he knows a lot.
You can see the difference in young Carl, man.
They're doing amazing, like top 20 in SA at the moment, or sorry, in the continent at the moment, and she's just been doing this for like 2 years, so I'm so proud of her and the incredible
work. Has life-saving lost her? Is this her thing now?
100%. She's done with life-saving, done with everything. She's like an athlete now. I'm the guy at home feeding the dogs, preparing the meals, and just like, come on, baby, you got this. It's so weird. It's such a flip.
Yeah,
man. So that was just incredible for me. Obviously, we got some time to go and do some family stuff in amongst the competing. She's competing all the time. I'm working. We never get to see each other anymore.
Yeah.
So we got an opportunity to take the dogs out and have a nice little walk, which I absolutely always love. So that was the little bit of me time that we did get to get.
When did you drive to Velkom to do this?
Bro, we are so blessed.
Where's the sun coming from?
So this was just before that storm came through. So that was Saturday, just as the wind started. And it was really great to obviously have that moment to balance, get some grounding and reflect a bit.
Seeing as you had the opportunity to reflect, when you see this dream of yours coming together now, the nuts and bolts of it literally coming together. Because I can remember when you were talking about the land, just like, oh, I've got this beautiful patch
of just barren
earth.
Land, yeah.
How does it feel now that this is all coming together in this sense? Because it couldn't get more real now. It's amazing, dude.
It is crazy. Every time I step into that building, I literally pinch myself, G, and I'm like, whoa. I mean, look at this community of people that are training in a space that was once just a concrete floor. And then you get inspired by people around you that build things and have this creativity, and you think, like, you start getting into it, you're like, you're never going to get there, but you just keep working and you just keep sacrificing. And then
you look back
again and you're like, whoa, there's something here. Now it's starting to look like something. It's absolutely incredible to be on this journey. The people that we have, G, the community, the space, it is just something that I can see myself spending a lot of time in, and willingly so. I love sharing, helping people grow, and just doing whatever I can, man.
By that he means franchises across the entire country.
Yeah, coming to a space near you.
That's what he means. Ah, we love it, man. Whether your weekend was very introspective like mine, very extroverted and out there like Riles, we want to hear from you guys this morning. Let us know what you got up to this weekend. What major milestones have you been achieving in your life? How good does that feel? And we'll continue that conversation as we progress throughout the show today. And of course, we promised you some inspiration, and we got that in bucket loads.
We've got bucket loads. We've got conversations coming up. We've got entertainment to take part. There are so much, there's so much emphasis, I think, on the youngsters that are coming through this morning. And we're seeing exactly that. We've got a superstar by the name of Lesedi that's come through that's going to be chatting to us about so much right now. And we're talking about someone that has a balance of life. They are studying. They look good. They are still showing up on live TV. I mean, look at that smile right now. That's the master student, Lesedi, that I've been talking about, chatting about balance, which I think is oh so important right now, especially as we gravitate towards this transition in the year. We're going into winter.
Sure.
We need to buckle down.
Yeah, man, it's all stations go. I love this. We're going to get industrious. And then, of course, Liam is here to perform for you. He has been treating us to his sound checks in between. If there's a reason why I've got, like, misty eyes, okay, he's going to hit you in the feels. This kid has got the talent to back up the promise, and we'll introduce you to him on the other side of this.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, yes, Mzansi, welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And let me tell you, the person we're about to chat to right now can make you feel so good, especially if you open up your ears, because joining us is a Liam Funder Hader. Now, he's an emerging singer, a songwriter who has decided to follow his passion for music, and we are so grateful for it. So just to give you a little taste of what we're talking about, have a listen and check this out.
I turned away.
Can we give him a big round of applause? This is on behalf of all the people walking on the prom that didn't applaud for you on that day because they should have, man. That you've now made famous. Liam, welcome to this little slice of crazy.
Thank you.
You must be crazy, bud. You're going all in, a career in music. Are you insane? Buddy, just give us a window into that process. Why have you decided to go all in? Obviously, the talent speaks for itself, but there is a deeper resonance here. Why music for you?
Yeah, so I found that I had a lot of fleeting passions over the years, but music was one that really sticked through all of them. And I found that during my exam time when I was supposed to study, all this music inspiration was coming, so I ended up making music instead of studying. So, it's just meant to be. I need to
just,
go to music.
Just meant to be. Well, let's talk about the studies for a bit. Conservation ecology, something that piques my interest and something that I love when it comes to... It's not that standard thing that you would study, right? What was the studies like? I mean, why choose that when you... Firstly, I know you got this passion, like, calling you, but you still got to find and choose something that still resonates with you in the meantime. Why choose that out of all things?
So I've always been passionate about the environment. Initially marine biology, but that was a way into it, basically. I love the creation, and I love analyzing it, preserving it. Which is one of my passions. I have many passions, by the way.
You got that creative brain, man.
And let it flow. I think this is the joy of the world that we live in right now. As you are, and we joke about this all the time, you can be professionally yourself. And that can be represented in different career lanes, in different guises, but it stems from kind of a purpose, something that gets you fired up and gets you going. When you talk about that musical creative journey, and we know you've got a song in the works at the moment, Your Mind is hopefully going to be released to the world, and I'm hoping you'll give us just a little snippet of it a little bit later in the show, but the creativity, when you've got to put something down, where does that come from? How does your creative process work?
So it stems from, I think, me eating like a beat on the desk while I'm studying, I think, specifically for music. So then I'm like, nah, I need to record this beat. And then it's like music in my head the whole
a spark.
Time.
Wait, does that just like come out?
But only when he's studying, You're going to have to do about 9 or 10 degrees throughout your life and just keep going and just see what beats come to you when you're studying archaeology. Yeah, you'll get it.
But I love that. That's something that reminds you of that like sort of jovial, raw period that I had. I remember being at school and we would say the same thing, gents, let's cup a beat. And you just kind of go with it and you see what comes out. And you are answering that call more than just having fun, more than just like, yes, you're taking it on as a passion,
career.
And in that moment, this is where I want to ask the question, because that's that pivotal moment where you decide, okay, cool, I want to make a career out of this. I want to present myself to the world. How do you determine and define what you are going to give to the world, right? This is your first time to present yourself with your image, with your music, with your style, with someone as creative as you, with someone that I believe can master almost any genre. How do you determine exactly what I'm going to penetrate the market with to make myself known, that arrival moment? How do you get that right?
So what I plan to do and what I aim to do is to really advertise South Africa and sort of the integration of the different cultures in South Africa through my music. And I plan to just create music that is relatable. To a lot of people. Okay.
There has been an inversion in the way that you can engage with your market now. And at first, when TikTok started putting its hand up, and we were like, but it's just another social media platform. It's not real. These aren't real artists. And then you start seeing artists starting their career in TikTok, sold out global tour. We've had artists come to South Africa that no one knew based purely on their TikTok back end. When you think about that opportunity, and you are speaking to individuals, and that's the joy of online, is you're speaking to that one person, possibly at the worst moment of their day, of their life, mm-hmm. your music gets to be that plug-in. Do you think about the other platforms? It's not just about getting a single out there and getting it onto radio anymore. You've got to engage. How do you feel about the opportunities in TikTok, in Reels, in using that space around you, man?
So I feel TikTok and Instagram and all those, they provide a brilliant opportunity for anybody. It just starts off by posting what you do. You don't even have to...
Just get going.
You just post what you do, basically. And if you're passionate enough, if you're hardworking enough, people will start noticing that you're going somewhere. So just put yourself out there. You never know what will happen.
For sure.
You never know. I mean, look where it ended up for you. And it's just getting started, bro.
Oh, no.
I love asking this question to some of the new talent that we get to see on the show, because crazy things can materialize. And myself and G have seen manifestation play out in the craziest ways, bro. Yeah. So you need to jump on this bus with us right now. I'm going to ask you this question, and I want you to be careful with how you answer this, because it will materialize, all right? So when it comes to your career, when it comes to how you envision yourself, who do you see yourself performing with? Where do you see that performance happening? And describe it for me, man, because this is going to happen. It's gonna take place.
It's gonna manifest, yeah.
Yeah.
So what I see myself, who I see myself performing with one day, someone that I looked up to a lot is Ed Sheeran, definitely.
Oh, nice,
Ed Sheeran.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Because I like the variety of music that he's involved with, even if it's like in the background production and so. I just like his variety.
And where are you gonna perform it? What are we gonna be singing about, bro? Come on, give me something here.
Let me think about that one. You know the song Perfect.
Perfect.
I just want to sing that song with him one day. Yes.
Maybe he'll fly to South Africa to perform you.
Yeah.
I would love that.
In fact, let's send him a little love note right now. Liam, we're going to let you go and take your spot on the stage. You can head off and go and get your head and your heart and your spirit in the zone. Go and pick up your guitar. We cannot wait to plug you into this young man's incredible talent. And I'm just saying that Ed Sheeran loves South Africa. He's not shy to come out.
Especially if he sees that guy's face. I mean, if you just think about Liam, the way he talks about his music, you can see how he lights up.
Real.
You can see he's got a secret he's hiding that he's waiting to share. And I'm telling you, the moment is just about to arrive. And this is what it's all about. Celebrating young talent, celebrating the potential of our South Africans, and looking at moments like this and realizing that it's a stepping stone to greatness. This one moment of many that will come, that it's going to absolutely change not only your life, but Liam's too. And right now, Mzansi, you get the opportunity to witness the first of many right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Enjoy.
Greetings, everybody. So the first song that I'll be performing is a song that I learned recently. It's I recently got into country music, so this song has really grabbed me in terms of country grabbing me. The song is Tennessee Whiskey by Chris Stapleton. And if you know the song, sing from under your blankets. It's fine.
I used to spend my nights out in a barroom. Liquor was the only love I know. Then you rescued me from reaching for the bottom and brought me back from being too far gone. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy, and honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time. I used to look for love in all the same old places. I found that the bottom of the bottle's always dry. And when you poured your love, I know I didn't waste it. 'Cause there's nothing like your love to get me high. as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. And honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. And honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time.
So my next song will be by Bruno Mars, also one of my biggest inspirations. This is Count On You.
Oh, if you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. And if you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Oh, oh. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3, and I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. That's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh, yeah, yeah. If you're tossing and you're turning and you just can't fall asleep, I'll sing a song beside you, yeah. And if you ever forget how much you really meant to me, every day I will remind you. Oh, oh. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3, and I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on. That's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh, 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 yeah, yeah. You'll always have my shoulder when you cry, yeah. I'll never let go, never say. And I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh, ooh, you can count on me cause I can count on you.
Beautiful. Well done, son.
Brother. Wow. absolutely nailed it. Thank you so much for sharing that. That was raw, that was real, and that was everything we came for. And it doesn't stop there, Mzansi. We've still got a whole lot more to look forward to in your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and we don't want you to go nowhere because we've still got an incredible, inspiring dance coming through from Limri Academy. That's the Dance Academy. And we've got an important conversation from Lesedi Lale. The man is talking about all things balance when it comes to life, something we can all take a page out when it comes to his book. So hopefully we can have that conversation going once again. But let us not forget this incredible talent. Let's put our hands together one more time and we'll see you in just a bit, of Mzansi. Ah, you got it, bruv. You got it.
There are stories of creators, and we're inspired by them all. We invite you to write your story with us. Your story matters. ABSA.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back, you beauties. This morning, we are going to learn more about what motivates and inspires the young people of today. You're still kind of young, so I think this is a bit more for you. But we know that there is a massive shift towards purpose and really going out there and grabbing those dreams, no matter how lofty they might seem. Technology and social media has opened a whole new world of career possibilities. And I think many choose to balance the pursuit of a less traditional career path and focus on being that while creating content around it. Now we are seeing the magic happen. Someone who is successfully doing just that with a brilliant, I think, brand of South African humor and, of course, over 600,000 followers on TikTok now is Lesedi Lale, better known as Creator Lesedi. Welcome to it. You got to applaud yourself, bro, because you are awesome, buddy. Welcome to this little slice of crazy. Thanks so much for being here.
Hi there. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. How are you doing, bro?
I'm doing well. I mean, I feel good. I'm at the Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
You don't have a choice.
Yeah. You look incredible as well.
Thank you.
We're not mentioning how incredibly stylish you are on top of everything that you're juggling right now. But before we get into what you are doing, let's take it back a bit, man. It's from Soweto, obviously.
Yeah.
Had an interesting upbringing. How does that upbringing and that sort of time in your life spark this interest in the science world, man?
Yeah.
I mean, if I were to take it back to Soweto, you know, I think the first thing that I have to start with is the humility, you know, in the place, you know.
Uh-huh.
I first learned that. And when it comes to science, you know, there were people who were inspiring me, you know, in my school. So I went to Maforim Pahlele High School, so it's a public school in the township.
Okay.
So amongst, you know, the students, or rather the learners at the time, there were learners that I looked up to, you know, who inspired
That's
me
brilliant.
To do science, you know, at the time, yeah.
Nice, okay.
It's so crazy because teachers can guide us. All we need is that mentor. We need someone to do that. Now, very often, I would imagine there weren't a huge amount of mentors that you could just reach out and connect with in the science space. So it's amazing that other older learners were there to guide you through that. But now we've got this platform, we've got TikTok that has just exploded, not just for dance, okay? Not just to drive brand, but as a platform for you to reach and effectively mentor more people. How did this all come together? Where was the content creation spark?
Yeah, so if I were to take it back to primary school even at the time, so wow. I've always had creative ideas, you know, growing up, but I didn't know how to execute them because channeled I didn't have, you know, resources or comprehension when it comes to producing content. So I think the turning point was in my matric year, so I used to watch this show every time, you know, Expresso. I think there were, yeah, this show, it was okay. It was Leanne Williams, it was Hugh Grime, it was Katlego Mabowe, and, you know, and Zoe Brown was here as well.
Oh, geez.
So that was at the time, and it inspired me a lot to produce content. So I remember after school, I used to produce my mini Expresso, you know, didn't make it out on social media, of course, but that was the idea behind content creation. So I think I knew that I had to have proper timing when it comes to content creation, because I knew that I want to be an academic at some point, you know what I mean? So I waited until I was in my third year in university. That's when I had the confidence to start my content creation.
Light the fire. Yeah. Light that fire. And now it's burning, bro.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
It is burning.
Burning bright. But let's talk about this. So third year now, we're at UCT.
Yeah.
You're doing your undergraduate. You haven't even attempted your master's yet. But yeah, like you mentioned just now, timing needed to be perfect. And yeah, somehow you managed that timing. Juggling all of this, studying the sciences at UCT while creating content. How was that journey like, man? That's challenging. I've been to that place. It had me, bro.
I was going to say, are all other students just lazy?
No, it's difficult. I mean, course is showing at the time, but I think the timing was perfect because it was in the second semester of my final year. So I had the confidence now to do other things because I knew I was near the finish line of my first degree. You know what I mean?
Way, yeah.
So I started, you know, covering events on campus. So I started with mini shows, you know, having a mic there presenting throughout, you know, the shows that we had on campus. Then from there on, after I graduated, I think that December of 2022, in my final year, that's when I started doing comedy now.
So it was all like a testing ground for you up until that point.
Proof of concept, yeah. You may have it like that if you like.
It's so crazy because when we get, so many people ask us for this TV plugin. And I will just tell them, because to you it looks like this is a structured job thing. We are just representing ourselves and our life path. And then we kind of intersect for these shows and these moments, but it's just one slice of. Just go out and do it. Just go and create your own content, create your own platform, go out there and do it. And you've done that. So I think you started your career years ago without even realizing it.
Mm. Yeah.
You can train, you can practice, but not everyone can be funny. Where does that come from?
Because
you could have just started and left there. You could have just been a comedian and kept in that lane, dude. You are very funny. Where does that come from?
Oh, that comes from way back. You know, I think I realized when I was in matric, you know, at the time. So when I was chilling with friends, you know, I'd get that Lord Dorai, man, you are too forward, you know. In our home language, you say wapapa, you know, like a lot of people would say that Dorai, hey, speed and do I need, you know what I mean? Yeah, you know what I mean? So I realized that, hey, man, I think I'm funny, you know. Even the teachers at school would pull me on the side and tell me that, hey, we know that you are too forward, but you must capitalize on this, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Use it to your advantage. So I think I've always had interest in sitcoms, you know. I've always been interested in, like, a lot of sitcoms that I can mention right now. So I think that the whole funny idea comes from a lot of sitcoms that I've watched.
And I think through that journey, you've clearly learned how to package. You've learned how to produce. And that's often where funny falls down. It's like everyone can be funny, but how do you put that into the right context, into the right place and plug in? And you've nailed it, dude.
You nailed it, man. You're nailing everything you touch, every space you play in. Where to next, bro?
Yeah, I think it has to be continuation. So I'm now working on managing whatever that I have for at least the next 1 year and 6 months, because also it takes a lot of research. You know, you speak of packaging and structuring things. You know, it takes a lot of research, sitting down and structuring, and also reaching out, or rather doing case studies with the people that have made it before. So it takes a lot of practice. So for now, I'd say it's management. Let's just keep it going. And then after 1 year, 6 months, we should have something.
Do you secretly have a team of writers sitting behind you right now giving you these answers? There's like three or four people sitting there just typing answers, or you've got AI plugged into your brain or something, bro. This is so impressive. I've sat next to industry moguls, people who have been in this game for 30, 40 years, who haven't got it this right, they're succinct in terms of their image of where they're going and how they're doing it. But you are impressive, my friend.
Oh,
and you're
you.
A good
thank
kid,
you.
Man.
That's kind, oh, man.
He's
just
thank
a kid.
You.
Just a kid. Remember this name, ladies and gentlemen, Lesedi Lale. Thank you so much again for sharing your time, inspiring yeah. us. I think everybody yeah. watching right now is going to get up and do something great with their lives, and that's thanks to you. So we look forward to seeing more of you, and yeah. whatever you touch is going to turn to gold, and I can't wait to chat about that. But of course, just reminded you that maintaining a balance is possible, clearly. And what about Lesedi? Journey as a student and content creator maybe inspires you the most, because we'd love for you to come through, share some of that inspo with us on our social media pages, and let's keep this gears and this good stuff going, man. I love it. Thank
you, brother. I have a feeling he answers DMs as well. I just have a feeling that he is there to connect and mentor you as well. So let's get a bit more motivation. Normally we just restrict the dancing for a Friday, but this Monday's got that kind of vibe, man. We just want to let go and continue to be inspired by just brilliant young South Africans, and the Limri Academy of Dance are exactly that. And of course, they are doing it on the biggest stages across the globe, and we were very lucky to bring them here to perform just for us, for Lesedi, this morning. Take it away, Limri.
Yeah.
I'ma be. I'ma be rocking over that bass trap. I'ma be chilling with my mother monkey crew. I'ma be making all the deals you wanna do. I'ma be up in the A-list flicks, doing one-handed flips, and I'ma be sipping on trickers. I'ma be shaking my head. You gon' be licking your lips. I'ma be taking them pics, looking all fly and shit. I'ma be the flyest chick. I'ma be spreading my wings. I'ma be doing my thing. Yeah. I'ma swing it this way. I'ma swing it that way. It's Becky Ferguson. I'ma be here to stay. The 21st century till infinity. Popping that bubbly, cooling and living that good life. Oh, let's make this last forever. Party and we'll chill together. On and 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 on. I'ma be rocking like this. What? Y'all want to talk? What? Why don't you put it on the blog? Rocking like this is my job. We can't help that we popular, and all these folks wanna flock to us. Come to a show and just rock with us. A million plus with binoculars.
Beautiful!
Wow!
Oh,
power!
So limber! My back is hurting. I think I might have got it like a herniated, and just watching that. They are amazing. The Limri Academy of Dance aren't going anywhere. We'll see if we can squeeze up one performance from them a little bit later, because they're just so awesome.
Yeah, man, I can't wait for that. And there's a lot more that you need to stick around for, Mzansi, because we are diving into the kitchen once again. It is almost upon us, and we've got something special for you to celebrate with, and that's a prawn curry. It's going to be delicious. Lemise is in the kitchen, and she's going to be sharing all that magic with you right now, Mzansi. It's going to warm up the heart, and it's perfect for this weather. And speaking of perfect, there's someone that wears clothing just perfectly.
Oh, you're talking about yourself?
No, he might even
be better.
It could be Lesedi as well, because he looks amazing as well. But this man's coming through with the goods. He goes with the name of Chad Haupt, telling all our gents how to wear a suit in the most incredible way we can. And we're going to dive into this conversation in just a bit. Look at him over there. Wow. Dapper.
He was one of the first, actually, that got my attention in this kind of menswear space. And I think I've been following probably longest.
I can see
why, because he's got balance right, man. Can the rest of us pull it off? Or maybe with a little bit of his help. We'll see you now. Only you can make my day.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Yes, Mzansi, welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and we've got some inspiration for you, especially those that are celebrating it right now. It's time to make this Eid a memorable feast with family, friends, and incredible food. Now, here to delight us with a delicious prawn curry that is absolutely perfect for the upcoming celebrations, and especially this weather, we've got chef and baker Lamise Abrahams in the building, and joined alongside her is the one and only Chef Clem. Chef Clem, good morning.
That's such an amazing welcome. Thank you.
Lamise, good morning. How are you doing?
Good, good, good. Thank you.
It's really exciting once again to have you in the kitchen. It's always an honor, especially this time of the year. Very, very spiritual time of the year, but more importantly, it's a time where we get to indulge in some favorites. And I know last week you were talking about so many favorites. You mentioned some of your mom's inspirations when it comes to curry. Is this a part of that inspiration?
Yes. So what I said was my mom's famous crayfish curry is like something I look forward to on Eid.
Yeah.
She makes it every Eid.
And tradition.
Tradition, exactly. But we will be making a prawn curry today.
Okay, so maybe
so
we can start.
So it's inspired by the crayfish curry.
I like that. Yeah. And obviously crayfish isn't always that accessible.
Exactly.
Prawns are a lot easier to get a hand of.
Yeah.
And I also think that this is allowing a new tradition to take place.
Yes.
So maybe we can instill and encourage that within some of our people right now.
Yeah.
Take me through the recipe. I know there's a lot of flavor and a lot of spices to get through. So, and I'm also here at your service.
Okay,
great. Okay. I'm going to swap. I'll go in the middle for a second.
Okay, all right.
There we
middle.
Go. I'll man the pans.
Man the pans. All right, Lamise, you are starting with the prawns on that side.
So,
all right, what are we doing first?
A kilo of prawns over here. So, basically, what we're going to do is we're going to form a paste with a little bit of prawn masala.
Okay.
A little bit of oil. Squeeze the lemon juice.
Are you pre-marinating your prawns, or is it literally
just
what
goes on
the
prawns? Yes, because I just want that flavor, you know, in the prawns.
So
we marinate it and just keep it in the fridge for like 20 minutes or half an hour before you actually fry them.
Okay.
So we're just gonna.
And I know obviously some people prefer the marination before. Some people like do it like almost like al dente, al fresco, and then you just add something afterwards, like a little bit of pepper and lemon. Is this part of that sort of family tradition? Is it a matter of like, look, we're always incorporating these specific spices that give us that nostalgic flavor?
No, that's
is that,
right. The
is
spices
that something
are very important.
And I mean, I know with all of our sort of recipe inspirations, it often comes from our parents, right?
Yes.
They have this like way of making something or these top tips when it comes to preparing meals. What top tips have you been able to absorb from your family, like in these years of preparing incredible meals?
Freshness, like the best ingredients and the freshest ingredients is quite important.
That makes a difference.
It definitely makes a difference in your dish. So, you know, like Woolworths has these amazing fresh prawns. I mean, you can get them in the freezer. They're freshly frozen.
Yeah.
And
sustainably sourced often as well, which is a stamp of approval.
Always first, yeah.
So just the freshest ingredients always, you know, help to make the best dish and always prepare. So always have everything ready like we do here.
Yes.
And then things just work smoothly and it goes smoothly and
that's something I can agree with because I had no idea how to cook whatsoever until I came to this show and saw how easy it is when you just prepare your ingredients.
Teacher.
And you have incredible teachers like
teacher. You spoke about prepare, right?
Yeah.
I've got the perfect example right here. So last week I did a video on the Taste TikTok page and someone was like, rinse your prawns.
Like it was rinsed.
But there's something about rinsing your prawns, right? You should only ever rinse your prawns once, and it's because of a hack.
Okay.
So when you fry your prawns,
yeah?
It's going to be frozen.
Huh?
Whatever you do, do not put your prawns in the water, okay? It literally removes so much flavor. When you smell the water, it smells like prawns.
Oh.
Because you've removed all that flavor. So if you look at this, people are like, you must rinse your prawns until that darkness is gone. That is very small, little dot of brown there. No. There's nothing wrong with it. It's actually like the flavor from the prawn, so don't do that. My hack is let your prawn thaw out at room temperature, never the water, and then when it does thaw out and it's soft, a little bit of salt on the prawns, and you kind of, almost like you brine chicken, you kind of plump up the prawns again. You give them back the essence of the ocean, give them that salt, they suck it up, that's the one time you rinse them, and you only rinse the salt off. If you keep on rinsing it, you're gonna end up with prawns that taste like nothing.
Just
so
emptiness.
Keep that in
all
mind
right,
when you make your
prawns. Great tip coming through
and
there right
do,
now.
Do take the vein out. Very important, and we didn't do that on the show. Always. There's never an excuse to leave the vein in the prawns.
Right.
If you're not willing to take the vein out.
So when it comes to maybe something like a purchase from Woolies, do I need to look out for that vein again, or has it been deveined already?
If you have a seafood counter at Woolies, you'll see the fresh seafood, the fresh prawns that they sell in the back of your pack. Those have been deveined. If you need a curry in a hurry, That's the one you get.
Okay.
Otherwise, the one in the box, which is this one over here, does have the vein in it. That's done because, obviously, so it stays... Because they want to freeze it as quickly as possible.
Yes.
Yeah.
Boom, that's it.
And keep so it as fresh as possible.
You know,
as well.
Exactly.
That obviously makes sense, right. So with all our fresh ingredients in front of us right now, how are we looking on the prawns? How long are we preparing this for? And what do we kind of need to look out for to know that it's done?
Just 2 minutes and you'll see it'll start changing color.
Okay, so I see that. Some pinkiness coming through there already. That's what we're looking out for?
Yeah.
All
so
right.
Then it's basically done.
Okay.
We're not just... We're still going to cook it in our sauce.
There's more to come. It's still going to absorb some of that goodness that you put together.
Can I do kind of work on the blender? Because see, I got peppers, so first, I got tomato.
Yes, so first we saute our onions, okay, with our spices and our garlic.
Well, if you don't mind me asking, what spices have you put into that? Because Zanzi always asks, what is that special ingredient? What is the special spices that makes it different? What have you got in here?
So in here we have a little bit of garlic, a chili, we have prawn masala,
ooh, yum.
And we have some jeera.
Nice.
Yeah.
And I think for the weather that we have right now,
this is amazing.
Absolutely perfect. This is going to give you that spice, that warmth, that comfort, the flavor and everything that you need to get this recipe on. All right, how's it looking? We're good?
Good.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do
is... this joining the blender?
That's correct.
Oh, nice. Okay, let me...
Careful, you that do is it, hot,
I will hold and you can scrape.
Okay. So in here we have two tomatoes and a green pepper. Here we have the onions, which we are going to transfer to our blender.
Nice.
So we're just going to blend all of these onions, spices, and these veggies together to form our sauce.
And is this the sauce
and then
that
we're going to cook it.
This essentially is the sauce that the prawns are going to be basking in, right?
Yes.
You want to put it fine just like that?
Yeah, it's fine.
No water, we're good. So at home, South Africa, don't blend hot stuff in your blender, especially if it's a vacuum cup like this.
Yes.
But we're professionals.
Are we?
Are we? Let's find out.
And that color, it looks amazing as well.
Yeah.
It does.
No. Okay, let me get the pot.
Okay. We're all just going to leave the kitchen. Ralph, just joking. No,
leave me with all these ingredients. I'll just finish it before the recipes are put together. But just a reminder, of course, for you and Zanzi, you can find Amuse's prawn curry recipe that we are doing right now at expressoshow.com. It is the perfect meal that can inspire anybody to get their seafood skills on, and also for Eid that is coming up. It's a great way to celebrate. But we are going to flash through the last moments of this recipe.
Yes.
Where are we at? What are we doing?
Okay. So to finish it off, we're just going to add a little bit of curry leaves just to give it that extra bit of flavor, a little bit of sugar.
Yes,
just
love
to
that.
Balance the sourness from the tomatoes, and a little bit of salt, salt to taste.
Mm-hmm. Very important with the curry also.
Yes.
It doesn't matter how good your blend is, if you don't have enough salt, you're not going to taste anything.
Okay.
And then we're going to finish it off with a little bit of coconut cream.
Oh, yeah.
And then we're going to add our prawns to this and just let it cook for like 5 to 10 minutes and then we're good.
Oh, we are.
And
definitely.
Then, of course, garnish with some coriander when we're done.
We are definitely good, Louise. Thank you so much. You made that look so simple. And to be honest, it actually really is. I don't think we needed two incredible chefs here to show us how it was done, but I'm grateful to have both of you here. Thank you for sharing your tips. Thank you for this inspiration. And for you, Mzanzi, this is another opportunity to celebrate moments that matter with friends and family. And you can shop everything you need for your Eid feast at Woolworths. It's available in-store, online, and, of course, on the Woolies app. What are you waiting for? The flavor. Oh, it's a winner-winner prawn dinner.
Yeah.
And I can't thank you enough, Louise. This is going to be added to my favorites. This is bucket list stuff from Zanzi. What are you waiting for? Get involved. Nice job. Well done. Oh, it smells good.
It does.
Oh, man, I'm having an absolute blast getting to know our performer this morning. Liam Vanaheda has been amazing so far in his performances, but even better for me to plug into someone who is so young and motivated. He's an emerging singer-songwriter who has just... gotten going. He has decided to go all in on his passion for music, but he's got such an incredible kind of background and so many tools to play with in this space. So thank you so much for sticking around and continuing the conversation with us. I've got to ask, first of all, how did that feel, young man, being able to sit there, perform songs that you love and you feel so deeply? What was that like?
It felt amazing, I must say. But I must say, there's a humbling thing that comes to mind. It's like when I'm performing a song, everything does disappear around me and it just feels like I'm performing at home. So I do feel very comfortable. I'm not so sure if you could see it, but I become completely comfortable when I start singing.
You go into that inner space, and that's a marker of some of the greatest music. I'm talking Callum Scott's, some of the best vocalists in the world who come here, and because we don't have a massive audience, a stadium full of people, you've got to go inward. And you see something truly remarkable, authentic about that. I love it. There is an opportunity now to have a, and I saw you chatting to Lacedi, there is content creation, collaboration opportunity. There are social media opportunities to reach bigger audiences. And if you think of your own journey now within the music space, within the content creation space, within the conservation space, all of these areas that you're expanding through, who do you want to work with locally? If you could have your superhero team around you, what would that look like, man?
So sort of, I would like to actually get involved with government in some way. Yes, because I believe there's a lot that can be done better. There's a lot that we've learned in my degree that could have done better, or resources could have gone to better places. Just if they were more inspired by the science.
For sure.
And not just all the politics.
Yeah, all of the politicking. Yeah, unfortunately, and around this time of the year, as we approach an election, the politicking just goes off the charts, and it kind of does dispel a lot of your faith, because you're like, oh, but you're just saying this to get votes, and I get that. But you back it up with the science. Now, you have an opportunity to help guide other young people, your contemporaries, even older artists with this way of thinking that you do. How do you see your music being able to do that? Is that something that you've thought about, the power? Because you give us the words to feel, really. That's what you musicians do for those of us who are not musically gifted at all. Is there a purpose behind your music?
So I have thought about it a few times, to integrate my sort of purpose with protecting the environment with my music. But for now, the ideas and the inspiration that comes in the form of music doesn't tend to take on such a route. But I do tend to think that I'll get into that one day, where I would cross the two over, basically, the music and protect the environment.
I love it, man. But look, you're a young man. You got big feelings. You got to sort those out, man. So sing about your feelings now. And he is going to be singing about his very big feelings. And of course, I'm hoping, giving us just a little snippet of some new music on the way. That's going to be heading to you in just a moment. But of course, still a jam-packed show on the way. We've got more coming from Chad, of course, one of the best-dressed gents on the planet right now. He was one of the original influencers in the menswear space. We cannot wait to introduce you to a very good-looking Chad Holt. He is going to be stepping into studio, and then we'll be stepping back into the kitchen for another scrumptious recipe. We'll see you now.
Yes, Mzansi, welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and of course, official duties must commence. It's gone 2 minutes past the hour, and we're going to start off with national headlines. Now, the Free State Department of Education is calling on learners who have been victims of corporal punishment to report such incidents. Now, spokesperson Howard Ndaba says it's concerning to learn that incidents of corporal punishment are still taking place at various schools across the province. Now, recently, a 12-year-old learner at Tubisi Primary School in Taba Nqu reportedly sustained injuries to her hands after allegedly being assaulted by her school principal with a plastic pipe. Now, the principal, aged 57, was arrested and remains in custody until his court appearance on Wednesday. Well, sticking to national headlines, the Minister of Police, Bheki Cele, says some 500,000 suspects have been arrested nationwide since Operation Shanela was launched in May last year. Now, several breakthroughs have been made in high-profile cases, such as seven suspects currently being tried for the murder of musician Kiernan Forbes, known as AKA, and the National Task Force investigating the Fort Hare University murders, which has so far arrested 24 suspects. Now, moreover, of late, two KwaZulu-Natal suspects, aged 33 and 41, have been arrested by the Hawks after allegedly kidnapping six people and demanding a ransom. Well, we now move over to international headlines, and Zimbabwe has introduced a new gold-backed currency called ZiG. Now, the name stands for Zimbabwe Gold, and it is the latest attempt to stabilize an economy that has lurched from crisis to crisis for the past 25 years. Now, unveiling the new notes, Central Bank Governor John Mashuvayanu said the ZiG would be structured and set at a market-determined exchange rate. Now, the ZiG replaces the Zimbabwean dollar that has lost three-quarters of its value so far this year. Now, annual inflation in March reached 55%, which is a seven-month high. Well, next up in our international headlines, Israel's military said yesterday it was reducing its number of soldiers in southern Gaza. Now, Israel and Hamas also confirmed yesterday they'd sent delegations to Cairo to join fresh ceasefire negotiations. Now, Qatar's Prime Minister Mohammed bin Abdul Rahman Al Thani will join negotiators from Egypt, Israel and Hamas. Now, yesterday, exactly 6 months ago, Hamas attacked Israel with some 1,200 people died and more than 250 were taken hostage. Now, about 33,000 Palestinians have died in the war between Hamas and Israel in Gaza since then. Now, lastly in our headlines, world-famous primatologist Jane Goodall has celebrated her 90th birthday with a unique tribute. Now, 90 top female photographers offering their work for sale over 90 days. Now, the initiative titled The Nature of Hope, 90 Years of Jane Goodall's Impact, features breathtaking images capturing nature's beauty, such as playful polar bears and snow geese taking flight. Now, the sale supports the Jane Goodall Institute's mission to protect chimpanzees and their habitats, with 60% of the proceeds benefiting this cause. Now, notable photographers including Jodie MacDonald and Tu DeRoy contributed alongside Goodall's own historic self-portrait from her early days in Tanzania's Gombe Stream National Park. Now, this event not only honored Goodall's groundbreaking research, but also celebrated this wildlife warrior's lasting influence on women worldwide. Well, that's the last in the headlines that we have for you. Here's the G-Man with one last dive into all things sport.
Well, we start with the Premier League, and it couldn't get more hotly contested. Liverpool's Premier League title challenge was hindered once again by goals from Bruno Fernandes and the man of the moment, Kobbie Mainoo, resulting in a 2-2 draw against their old foes, Manchester United. So despite dominating the majority of the game, Liverpool needed a late penalty from Mohamed Salah to salvage that point. So the draw, as a result, leaves Liverpool behind Premier League leaders at the moment. Arsenal just on goal difference, though, and just 1 point ahead of Man City in what is going to be a tightly contested title race. Now we turn to rugby, and holders La Rochelle, they secured their place in the quarterfinals of the Champions Cup with a hard-fought 22 in a previous pool stage meeting, but certainly turned that around. Meanwhile, the Bulls, they've advanced through to the quarterfinals after a dominant 59-19 win against Lyon, and as a result, they will face Northampton's Saints in the next round. And we stay with rugby news, not the best news, unfortunately, as the Blitzbooks continue to, well, frustrate themselves with a disappointing finish at the Hong Kong Sevens, setting for sixth place after a loss to Fiji in the fifth place playoff. So Fiji claiming fifth place with a convincing 33-14 dominance over the Blitzbooks, and we don't see that very often. Despite the setback, the Springboks Sevens camp did say they've showed some improvement compared to their 11th place finish in the previous tournament in Los Angeles, but not difficult to rise from that. Next up, of course, the Blitzbooks will be in Singapore, and the Singapore Sevens League from the 3rd to the 5th of May will hopefully see that turnaround. And then finally onto Formula One, triple world champion Max Verstappen is looking very strong this year. He secured a commanding victory at the Japanese Grand Prix, leading his teammate Sergio Perez to a dominant 1-2 finish for a dominant Red Bull. Verstappen starting from pole position controlled the race from start to finish, claiming now his third win of the season. And he finished 12.535 seconds ahead of Perez. And then Ferrari's Carlos Sainz taking the third place spot on the podium. But Red Bull, well, pretty much unstoppable right now. Let's hope the same doesn't apply for your journey to work. Let's get the latest on the traffic front, bearing in mind the crazy weather across the land. Then we'll get into the weather.
Thank you so much, G-Man. Yes, let's dive one last moment into the thing we call traffic and see how we can assist you. And we're starting off in Benoni, Johannesburg. Now, there's been a multi-vehicle accident on the N12 westbound at Putfontein Road. Now, two lanes are closed and this is resulting in slow-moving traffic. So please heed this warning and travel safely. We move over now to Cape Town in Alsace River and there's flooding between 35th Avenue and Lavis Drive. And this is near Modderdam direction and that's towards Alsace River. So again, please be cautious when passing through this area. Now, there's also a lane closure. So you, when you approach this affected area, please do so with caution. But sticking to Cape Town now and in Somerset West, there's also congestion on the N2 outbound. Now, this is at Victoria. So again, you can expect delays and do allow for more travel time. And please do maintain a safe following distance on these wet roads. Now, we're going to stick to the Western Cape again, and there are multiple road closures due to adverse weather conditions. As you can see from the visuals right now, please make use of alternative routes and exercise caution while driving through these areas, and specifically these roads that we have put up on our screens right now. And again, I think for anybody heading out on the roads this morning, please buckle up, stay safe, and plan accordingly. From the roads now, we head to the sky one last time to find out what's happening in the world of weather. Yeah, now welcome to this thing we call weather, and diving into weather news right now, the SA Weather Service has issued severe weather warnings for the Western Cape. Now, an orange level 9 alert forecasts disruptive rain leading to widespread flooding, endangering lives, causing property damage and affecting transport in the Overberg and Southern Cape Winelands. Now, the city of Cape Town and the Swartland and Witzenberg municipalities face an orange level 6 warning, and that is for potential road and bridge damage. Now, on top of this, an orange level 6 alert warns of severe thunderstorms in parts of the Eastern Cape, the Northern Cape, the Northwest and the Free State. Now, this is causing flooding and severe disruptions. Now, a yellow level 4 warning is also issued for sea navigation with difficulties which extends from Saldanha Bay all the way to Plettenberg Bay. Now, moreover, a yellow level 2 warning is out for Gauteng, and that's due to thunderstorms and localized flooding. Now, lastly, residents in the northern parts of the Eastern Cape should prepare for heavy rain, flooding, strong winds, and especially cold temperatures. And I think for anybody out there in South Africa today, please stay safe and heed these warnings. For now, though, let's see how we can turn things around and share our last sunrise view of the hour. And this sent in from our family. And this is Luis G. Cherry from Alberton. And if you look closely, this is actually an incredible shot. It looks like she's captured lightning in the daytime with rain. So it's raining cats and dogs and it's lightning. This is unheard of. This is South Africa. And this is real. Wow. Insane stuff. And this is happening right now in South Africa. Again, as beautiful as this does seem, it does come with a big warning for everybody out there. Again, as we have mentioned, stay safe in this weather and please plan accordingly if you are heading out on the roads again. But again, thank you for sharing these incredible pictures. We'll do it again tomorrow morning. The number is 063-408-8863. For now, though, let's take one last look at those temperatures that you can expect on your side of town. Thank you.
Now, this is the thing we call Lotto, okay, because it's big. I know we get ridiculously excited, but we know that this is going to change someone's life, which is why. So we want you to start your week on the best possible note, a winning note, by playing your daily Lotto today for an estimated 480,000 Rand jackpots. And if you want to make every day feel like Kepe Day, then you need to actually play. Just do it, man.
Get involved. Now, luckily, there are so many ways to buy your tickets. And let me tell you about it. You can do it in store. There's the nationallottery.co.za website. You can use the mobile app, or you can also purchase a ticket through your cell phone banking. Now, on top of this, you can also dial *120*7529# and follow the USSDs. You've got options, people.
Yep, and we'll keep all of those options up on our social media platform so that you've got no excuse to go and check them out and then just do whatever's easiest for you. Put yourself in running. 480,000 Rand. That's life-changing. That is the estimated daily Lotto jackpot, and it could be yours, but you got to play now to put yourself in the running.
Yeah, you do. Now, also, what you need to do is stick around, because G and I have been trying to elevate our looks this morning,
right? Posture changed.
And you're looking good. The suit pants work. My jacket's working, but there's someone that's going to come through now and obliterate this style and elevate it to another level. We're talking about the one and only Chad Haupt in the building. Look at this, Mr. of Dapper, the Lord of Suave. You could not look more sexy than this in a suit, and this man's going to give you every reason and insight into how to look this good right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Mzansi.
In fact, it might make you feel so good you want to dance. The Limerie Academy of Dance is here to perform one more time for you. They are incredible. In fact, we're just continuing on the trend of inspirational, amazingly talented young South Africans. You can plug into that after this.
There are stories of dreamers, and we're inspired by them all. We invite you to write your story with us. Your story matters. ABSA.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. Oh, yes, Mzansi, welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And I think I need to add a little bit of elegance and poise to this next intro, because we are all about celebrating the youth of South Africa, right? Now, joining us right now is a style consultant and content creator. He goes by the name of Chad Haupt. Ladies and gentlemen, look at this dapper specimen right here. How are you doing, bro?
I'm good, dude. Thank you so much for having me.
It's an absolute pleasure. I'm honestly just admiring everything about you from top
to toe. It just looks incredible, all put specifically together. Thank you for coming through, and thank you for sharing this incredible content that you're sharing, man. We've seen you online. You are highlighting the dapper gentleman, why it's important for gents to be grooming to look this good. But from your mouth, from the man himself, firstly, good morning, and tell me, why is it so important to look this good, bro? Because really, you do, man.
Well, firstly, thank you so much once again for having me. And then thank you for the compliment, I guess.
I'm just being honest, bro. Yeah.
Yeah. So to me, it's really important for a man to take care of himself today, especially in the times that we're living in. Mm-hmm. I think for what I do, the content speaks to more than just a few. Like, it can be from the age 13 all the way to the age 65.
Yeah.
So I think it's really important that you groom yourself well. For example, there's three things I always tell people. When you groom yourself, it highlights three things.
Okay.
It highlights your best features, right?
Uh-huh.
It gives you the confidence when you walk out there. You feel good, you get a haircut. You know how it goes?
Feel good, yeah.
You shave.
Good, yeah, for sure.
And then lastly, women. The opposite sex. They always love a well-groomed man. I mean, look at yourself.
And that's it. I think for a gentleman that's gone through that sort of period, that is very intimidating. Being able to be confident around the opposite sex or any gender that you're trying to attract is very intimidating. And I think having the suit of armor, so to speak, really assists in these endeavors, right?
Yeah.
Adds to that confidence, adds to that poise, adds to that charismatic look that you have. But for you, I mean, it doesn't stop there. You actually, what I believe, a style consultant, right? So not only are you sharing what I believe is valuable tips for a lot of gentlemen, and like you said, kids trying to get into the space of looking good, gentlemen that have never known how it works and trying to figure out, you're providing us with those solutions. You're providing us with the ability to take three suits, turn it into 30, and I love that. But where does your passion for looking good, your passion for style, where does this even like stem from? Like, what started it all?
Yeah, so growing up, I always used to, so my late grandfather, may he rest in peace, he was the one that always looked this way.
Okay.
So he passed away when I was very young. So what I remember about him is he always wore a jacket. He was always like well-polished shoes. Like, he just looked the part. He was
He's look at impact, eh?
He's definitely my inspiration. And then I have to quote someone I look up to. Although he's a fictional character, James Bond.
Oh, God, who could not? And I was going to say, bro, if there was ever a need for a new James Bond, I'd push you into that role so hard, bro.
Wow.
You look like it. Yeah, and I can see that. Is it more like, for me, you know, growing up, you see, like, beautiful cars, you see suits, you see these things of success. I think looking good definitely plays into that sort of facet of growing up and becoming successful, right?
I have to agree with that, eh? So one of the first things people notice about you is, of course, I don't know you, for example. I walk in and I see you in a room. What's the first thing I see? Your outfit, right? Mm. How you present yourself, your grooming. But what I want to stress is my content is not just about how you look on the outside. It's important to take care of yourself inside as well.
Yes.
Spiritually, mentally, like, for example, going to gym, eating a well-balanced diet. All of these things come together to create one single man.
It does, and I love how you've put that, because for you, you've taken this in your stride and you've actually put more than just all your heart and soul into this. You took a big leap, right? You quit your 9-to-5 to pursue this and to share these sort of, I think, valuable insights with so many people. And like you said, these are tips that are helping people navigate a very intimidating space. That must be daunting, right? You're quitting your 9-to-5 to do this, and you're doing it because you believe in yourself. But to get external validation from the likes of brands like GQ as an example, that's huge, man. I think for young kids looking up to brands like this as well, this is that stamp of approval. You reached the summit, bro. You've made that moment happen for yourself. It's materialized. What does that feel like? Going from, okay, I'm going to take a risk, I'm going to quit the job, and ending up at this moment that you're in right now, this is huge. Talk to me about this feeling, man.
Look, it's...
Look at that smile on your face.
It's, like you said, it's definitely a transition, right? It's not easy. I have to add that. Like every other business, you have to start somewhere. Quitting your 9-to-5, wow. I haven't told anyone about what I'm about to do. I walked into the office and I made up my mind and this is what I'm going to do. Look, you have to have self-belief. You have to trust in yourself.
Having your parents, just like, your parents are going to kill me. My parents are going to kill me. Like, what?
Well, like, yes, bro. Yes. Oh. I was still living at home at the time, like with my parents. So I had to rely on them and the little to no savings I had in my bank account. So wow. It's definitely, you have to believe in yourself. You have to have faith. Having a good support system. And if you have a goal for yourself, you have to keep going, no matter what. I have to, yeah.
Well, listen, Chad, thank you so much for coming through. I know we're harping on how you look, and I know it can sometimes be caught up in such a material conversation, but you really are bringing the connection to not just a material facade, but there's so much deeper meaning and value in that. And I love how you bring that across. I love how you are helping gentlemen navigate this intimidating world of being stylish, being able to bring your best foot forward, and you are entering that space so perfectly, man. So thank you so much for what you're doing. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know about this man already, well, there's a little bit more about him, but you definitely need to see his stuff online. It's so incredible. It's something that's gonna help you look your best, and you definitely wanna give this man a follow if you can. For now, though, we're gonna be following him and also following our way to G-Man because he's got something special to chat about right now. Great stuff, Chad.
Thank you so much.
Yep, we're gonna be following everybody to the island and so much about what was spoken about between these two gems of gentlemen sat beside me plays a part in what we're about to talk about, and you'll understand why. So Tropica Island of Treasure is heading to Zanzibar, as we know, and the new amazing host for this season is our own Zanele Potelwa. She's just going to be amazing. And you could be pairing up with the most incredible list of celebrities duking it out on Zanzibar's white beaches. So we've got Hungani and Ndlovu, Ndavi Nokeri, Nkobile Kwezi, Carl Kuchelman, Bobby van Jaarsveld, hashtag beat Bobby, Chad Jones, and Omutle Gela. This is superstar status, all heading to Tropica Island of Treasure. Bobby, I'm just joking.
Man,
I love you, man.
I had to jump on this, bro. There's so much flames on this one. And for you, all you have to do is upload your audition video telling the Tropica team why you should go to the island to social media. Now, you can use the hashtag Tropica, and don't forget to tag My Tropica. Mm-hmm. And you can also upload your audition video to the link found on the My Tropica pages, or send it through to tropicaauditions@gmail.com. Really as simple.
You know,
as
everyone's going to do all of that.
Yeah, all
everyone's
of it.
Everyone's going to think that if I do it in everywhere, you only need to use one of those platforms. You don't have to do it on everyone to improve your chances. But the process is really smooth. It's been proven, worked through. It is brilliant. The most important thing, and that's why I think the conversation you just had with Chad is so pertinent for this. You've got to believe in yourself. It's not just about looking the part, you've got to feel the part.
Yeah.
We've got to see the second that that camera connects with your eyes, that connection, we want to feel who you are and the motivation. We want to feel that fire burning in your eyes. We want authenticity.
Yes, please.
Don't play, because you'll get found out when the chips are down during these challenges. Your real personality will come out.
The pressure will bring it out of you,
exactly,
for sure.
Exactly, man. What do you think is going to... And we've seen a couple of stars emerge. Social media superstars emerge out of Tropica. What do you think they need to do as their first marker?
I think you definitely need to, like G says, be yourself, be raw, and give everything that you can. I think a lot of the time we're too hesitant to show all our cards or to reveal ourselves, but you got to take the moment, grab the bull by the horns, and express yourself. Really showcase who you are and what you're capable of, because I think that's going to make the difference.
Because you're selling yourself. You're not just selling your brand, obviously, to Tropica, because they want to know that you're going to represent what they do out on that island. So you need to be smooth. You know, we want a bit of polish. That's great, but not at the expense of that authenticity. So if you're going to be if there are things that you're not good at, be honest about that, and then hype up the things that you are really good at, so your partner can know what you're about. And I would give you a lesson that I continually learn in this job, because there's always so much to say. Try not to ramble too much, okay? Just stick to those hardcore points. Have a bit of structure. Mm. I think we can take a leaf out of Lissetti's book.
100%.
Plan what you want to do and then try to execute
Love it, G-Man. We make every word pertinent. Now, here's a reminder that the lucky seven contestants chosen to head to the Tropica Island of Treasure will receive 10,000 rand. That's before even getting to Zanzibar. And that's courtesy of D-Pete. So thank you for coming through on that one.
Yeah, that's in case you got really active in your audition video. Then you can just sort yourself out. Those auditions are going to close on the 5th of May. The clock is seriously ticking now. So get posting for your chance to win your share, your half, in fact, of 1 million rand. Ooh. Now that is smooth.
We're in Zanzibar for Tropical Island of Treasure. Are you? Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth million rand fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the hashtag Tropica and tag at MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island.
Ah, well, while you map out the structure of your audition video, we will continue to inspire you this morning. Maybe you want to put a little bit of dance in there to show your physical capabilities. We've got some of the best young dancers in the land. I would say probably in the world in their age group.
100%.
The Limerick Academy of Dance are going to perform one more time just to make it feel like a Friday.
Yeah, and then we're going to perform something a little bit different in the kitchen once again. It's something that you can't use for your audition, but you can use to make all your times a good time. We're talking about a beautiful lamb roast. It's something that's seasoned with vegetables. It is the perfect balance and...
look at that.
Ooh, say no more. I want this in my belly.
Do you think this is what it looks like to Carl in the kitchen every time? Like,
is this the view, yes?
Oh, man, it must be amazing.
Wow.
I'm sorry, buddy.
Yum,
I love
yum,
you, Carl. I love you, boy. Welcome back, you beauties. Time to dive into the world of entertainment news and catch up on what some of our favorite celebrities have been up to, what's been happening over this last weekend. I love it when there is so much South African connection to the superstar celebrity status here. But of course, when it comes to superstar celebrity status, well, there is one couple and only one couple. We're talking about Beyoncé and Jay-Z. They are just everything. And they also are the picture of a perfect union. And that's why I love this story. I'm going to kick it off with their 16th wedding anniversary. How old do you feel right now? I can remember them getting married. I don't understand this. And even though the couple's romance hasn't always been plain sailing, with the couple dealing with some infidelity rumors back in 2014 from the rapper's side, of course, they've worked through it together. And fast forward to 2024, and it seems that despite the couple celebrating their 16th wedding anniversary, Jay-Z's alleged infidelity still cuts Bey deep. Whoa. And on her Cowboy Carter album, the hitmaker croons the Dolly Parton hit Jolene, with her changing the lyrics to seemingly reference Becky with the good hair. She sings Jolene, Jolene. I won't even try and sing it like her. Jolene, Jolene, I'm warning you, don't come for my man. Jolene, 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 don't take the chance because you think you can. Oh, man, we've got Chad here with us. Buddy, how much fun is it to see this playing out? You've got to love a couple like this, okay? And obviously, stylistically, I doubt there is a more powerhouse couple. Are they the it couple on the planet, do you think?
Wow. to be honest with you, it's not my style. So, but each to their own, right?
Like 100%.
You decide how you wish to dress and
how do you put yourself out there.
Yeah. But in terms of music and entertainment, I would say they are right up there.
I love it. And I love the fact that they are, like, you get to live their life with them.
You do. You see everything almost.
Literally everything. Can you imagine you having a cut on air at your wife about, like, and not that there's ever been infidelity within your wonderful relationship, but it's that kind of thing. It's crazy, man.
It is crazy, man. It's crazy for me to also think that, like, you get these icons, and I love to maybe have this chat with you, Chad, because
We've seen this change in style, and especially with icons like this, coming from these beautiful suit eras to this oversized sort of era. I saw you online actually sharing a version of the two. Yeah. What do your audience think about this variation in style that's come through right now?
Basically the 90s and the noughties coming back. Yeah.
What is it like from your perspective and with your fans? I see you had some good comments there.
Look, I definitely had some fun with that. Like, it's something I've never done on my channel before, but in my case, I've educated my audience to this specific look.
Yes, yes.
So when I put out something like that, it always leans towards this, which is a good thing for me. Like, yeah. I'm doing the right thing then.
You're backing yourself. No, 100%. No, we go through this every day when we get dressed, and we've got an amazing style department here on air that has to coach us through what's happening. Yeah. So now let's hit some emotion here. Rapper Glorilla recently appeared on the Tamron Hall show, and there is a reason why this stood out. It seems she didn't anticipate the sweet surprise the host had in store for her. Ooh. Which was a sweet video message from her father. Let's take a little look.
A lot of people are rooting for you, but one person wanted to leave a special message for you. That's my Southern accent, can't get the special out. Take a look here.
Okay.
I'm the father of Glorilla, otherwise known as my baby, Gloria Woods. I am very proud of my daughter. She has risen from humble beginning to going to the White House. I am extremely proud of Gloria, and may she have many, many more days of success.
That was special. Hey? Come on.
And maybe this is something for you to take on board, buddy. Everyone has to start somewhere, man. It's if there was that person, that influence in your life that you would probably tear up to right now if we had to drop a message, who would that person be for you, man? Don't cry. I'm crying in this case. So if you burst out crying, I'm going to cry. Yeah, then he's definitely going to cry, man.
Honestly, I can't point to one specific person. But like I said, I was inspired by movies and my grandfather. If I could tell him today how I've taken his name and really done something with it, so... Oh, goodness.
I think if he had to see you in that suit right now, he might shed a tear, dude. There's something beautiful about that. I think I'm going to get a little bit emotional just thinking about it. I had a very similar relationship with my grandfather, so I get that, man. But we are there for that emotion.
We're there for that, man. We're there for all these insane, incredible stories. There's one more that I'll quickly want to share with you, Mzansi, and that's bringing it back local. Now, the inaugural Cultural and Creative Industry Awards ceremony took place this past week. Now, firstly, actress Nomzamo Mbatha won Best International Actor for representing South Africa, and of course the one and only Tyler, who made a special trip to SA for the awards ceremony, was also one of the night's big winners, and that was for Best International Act. Now, the awards aim to recognize and appreciate the outstanding contributions made by South Africa's top and leading creatives in the various creative sectors. Now, I absolutely love this story. I love celebrating our South Africans, and I love the fact that they're putting so much effort into coming home and making this a big deal, because it is.
It would have cost her about $50,000 to fly back to South Africa. So let's just put that in perspective.
Yeah,
it was like, Tyler, come home. Have you seen how much aeroplane tickets cost
over
right now?
Easter.
If she's doing 3 or 4 flights a month between the countries, literally dropping a few $100,000. When you see South Africans doing what they do at the moment, it's got to make you inspired. And you inspire us, buddy. So thank you so much for being that. For the old school gents, thank you for being representing that. For all of the young, incredible, motivational South Africans making your mark, thank you for being just that. In fact, let's answer that with a bit of dance inspiration right now.
Yeah, let's bring it on. Limerick's Academy of Dance is coming at us with round 2 of their magic. So sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Est-ce qu'il y a que moi qui ai la télé et la chaîne culpabilité? Mais faut bien changer les idées, pas trop quand même, sinon ça repart vite dans la tête. Et c'est trop tard pour que ça s'arrête, c'est là que j'aimerais tout oublier. Du coup, J'ai parfois eu des pensées suicidaires, j'en suis peu fier. On croit parfois que c'est la seule manière de les faire taire, ces pensées qui me font vivre un enfer. Ces pensées qui me font vivre un enfer. Et je sais vraiment pas quoi faire de toi. Justement, réfléchir, c'est bien le problème avec toi. Tu sais, j'ai mûrement réfléchi. Et je sais vraiment pas quoi faire de toi. Justement, réfléchir, c'est bien le problème avec toi.
Wow. I was just waiting for the trumpet to be all over myself with that. Oh, man, an incredible collective of amazing young dancers. Lemery doing an amazing job as their mentor and choreographer. Yeah. Thank you so much for that.
Definitely thanking you and thanking everybody that's been on the show this morning. It has been absolutely exceptional, it celebrating has. Young talent. And speaking of talent, the one and only talented Liam is still standing by. He's got his third performance coming up, and it's a beautiful single that we've been dying to talk about. And now we get to celebrate it.
Yeah, he's going to give us just a little, I hope he's going to give us a little taste of the new music on the way. And then, of course, we're back in the kitchen to whip up a scrumptious leg of lamb.
Yum.
Look at that. Oh. Oh, some beautiful seasonal vegetables around it. We will start dining after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Now, if you are still on the lookout for some gorgeous Eid recipes, then stay tuned, because today we are making a mouth-watering dish fit for a very special occasion, as it must be, a succulent leg of lamb, mm-hmm. cooked to tender perfection, served with delicious seasoned and seasonable vegetables. So this dish will surely impress your entire family, even that auntie who is impossible to impress. We might just win her over with this. And of course, we want to bring the loved ones around the table. And Lamise is here to bring us all around the table. I've noticed, because I'm on intermittent fasting on and off quite a lot now, And I would imagine for a lot of my Muslim friends right now who are fasting, looking at this food must be quite a challenge. So I appreciate the fact that you are here doing this right now. And it's part of that journey. And of course, this journey then culminates with a beautiful moment of connection, of spirituality with the whole family around the food, which means the food's got to stand up. Exactly. It's got to be good. So how are we going to elevate this gorgeous side of lamb for our Eid table?
So what we're going to do is, firstly, we're going to start off with marinating our meat. Okay, just a little bit of garlic.
I might be being overly simple here, but why do we marinate the meat? I mean, here you've got beautiful fats inside it. It's got a lot of its own flavor, especially a red meat like this. What does the marinade add to the end result?
The marinade just helps the flavors stick to the meat so that it comes through while you're cooking it.
Okay.
You know, because you want to rub it in there, get it inside. So what is really nice is you can make slits.
Ooh.
Like this.
And I suppose the answer's in the question, because you've got all of these beautiful fats that can render that flavor development, it's going to literally be cooking within cooking as it goes.
Exactly.
I love that.
So a little bit of oil, and this is just a basic lamb rub.
Okay.
Do you want to get in there, or should I?
I don't mind. I've sanitized and washed my hands. I will do that with absolute pleasure.
So we're just going to give it a good rub.
Okay. Okay. I'm going to get that. And obviously, you want to get it into all of the fibers.
Yes, and get it into those little crevices that we created.
I love that. The flavor profile of the spices that you're going to adorn our lamb with, what is the kind of your go-to in terms of what's going to let the lamb
Definitely some garlic, and then obviously rosemary. You know, a little bit of thyme and rosemary really brings out the flavors of your lamb.
And I suppose there is a reason why we keep using these usual suspects
for
that, because they just sing. It works.
Yeah.
Mm, absolutely love
that. Then we're going to pop that in the oven.
Okay, can I pop this in right now? In fact, I'm going to pop it across here. There we go. Now, I would imagine when you're developing flavors in a size of meat like this, you've got to be quite careful and kind of intentional about how you cook it.
Yes.
How long do we leave it in? When do we check? How do we know that it's perfect?
We could put some foil over it and just leave it in there for about 2 hours.
Okay, so you can give it a good go.
Yeah,
give it
and also, just before it's done, you can pop in some carrots, butternut, potatoes, and before you pop them in there, you just drizzle this with some oil. And this is just a basic veggie sprinkle.
Oh, wow. I like that.
Just to bring out the flavors of the veggies as well.
Because we often forget you've got like a flavor bomb here in these vegetables, but if you don't activate it, if you don't give the complementary flavors to let it sing, you're wasting it,
And then just a little bit of salt and pepper.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
And the fact that these can go in with the lamb and that those flavors can all develop together, absolutely exquisite. How do we know our lamb is ready? Would you use a thermometer as a fail safe, or is there a way that I suppose you've got reached that point where you can just give it the knuckle, the knuckle test, and you're like, okay, it's ready, it's done.
Well, you'll be able to see the juices it will be like a nice color, brown color, it'll be golden brown, and when you cut it, there'll still be some, you know, it'll be nice and saucy.
Yeah, unctuous. Because a lot and I suppose the resting becomes important there as well, because that draws a lot of the moisture in.
Yeah.
So we've cooked it for our 2 hours or thereabouts. How long do you need to let a size of red meat like this, especially lamb, rest before you serve it? Just in terms of, because it's quite a production line, the eat table.
Sit for like an hour or so, just so that all the juices can marinate and all the flavors can come together. And then serve it on a beautiful platter with some, we could also do some squash on the side, which you could add some more veggies or corn, and then top it with some cheese and pop that in the oven as well.
Ooh,
you know, when the cheese melts.
For sure.
And with some yellow basmati rice.
It's exquisite. So I'm thinking Eid dinner table, absolutely amazing. But I'm thinking about the joy of the leftovers the following day.
Oh my
gosh. If they're going to be leftovers.
Guys.
Oh, that's
slice
the best.
This up, put it in a flatbread or a pita bread. Absolutely
that's
amazing.
That's why I came on board, because I saw this is reminding me of one of those big Sunday meals that you make with the family, which always reminds you of the leftovers.
For Monday. Monday's lunch.
Exactly, and that got me excited because I would do so many different things with this because I knew, firstly, I'm getting my protein in, so that means gains for the week coming from the lamb, but also the great carbs. So I don't know if you've ever done this, but this is a great way to make like a proper like club sandwich is you take your, if it's a potato or anything that's sort of like a starchy, right, and you plonk that on top of your meat and then you sandwich it. Guys, let me tell you, have you ever had that sensation of like a pie?
Yeah,
in a sandwich?
For sure.
That's what's up.
Gee whiz, I'm buzzing up from excitement about food. Okay,
the leftovers, man.
You can see who's fasting at the moment as well, which is crazy to me. I think while we've got you here to plug into, and again, I've got to say thank you for fasting while we are dealing with so much food.
Putting it through the most, eh?
I know, it really hit me this morning. I was like, oh my word, this is quite a thing. But you've done this before. There is a lot of expectation on your shoulders in terms of getting the Eid table right.
Mm. Yeah.
What advice, well, first, what's your vibe? What are you going for this year for yourself? And what advice do you have for those that are going to be doing the hosting for this celebration?
Okay. Well, this year I'm doing a very neutral theme. My sister and I, my sister is actually an event planner.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Yeah, so she's really good at doing all the table setting and ordering all
perfect
of those
goodies.
Perfect union,
yeah.
It's going to be a shindig. Yeah.
Yeah. And then my mom is good at cooking and I'm good at desserts. So we've got a good combination.
If you're the
there.
One saying that the mom is good at cooking, yet you're the one we go to teach us how to cook, I can only imagine. What is your mom's name?
Shahida.
And you must be the best chef in the world.
I was just thinking there's just two things missing out of that. So you've got everything perfect, but you don't have two incredible eaters. And she and I are available. So, if you have an extra table or two, we can put on
noodles.
You're just going to have to put up with his pie sandwich thing at the end of the day.
He's going to come through as well for the leftovers.
I'll love it.
Always more than enough.
And then just from an emotional side, because there must be a lot of pressure and you want to enjoy the celebration, but you've got a job to do to cook. So any advice for those that are setting their table?
Preparation is key, basically. So just prepare all your steps that you need, and this is a real time saver.
Go and execute and bring in your mummy if she's good as that. But you can find this particular recipe as simple as it is for the perfect side of a leg of lamb with all these scrumptious vegetables. You can find it on expressoshow.com.
All right, so those are the leftovers, right, that you were speaking about, right? These are the leftovers.
I suppose technically, yes, Raul.
That looks good, guys. Well done.
Okay. So. Mama, you can make my day. All right, bottom line, you could start your week on a winning note by winning an insane amount of money if you play Daily Lotto today for an estimated 480,000 Rand. That's the jackpot, and you can make today feel like Cap Hay Day. Well, pretty much every day for the rest of the year feel like Cap Hay Day with your interest that you're earning. Beautiful.
Pretty much. But listen, if you want to get involved in this, then you have to do the following. You've got to buy your tickets, right? Uh-huh. And you can do it in the store. You can go to the nationallottery.co.za website. Mm-hmm. You can go to the mobile app, and you can also purchase a ticket through
the cell phone banking, or you can dial *120*7529# and follow the USSDs. Simple as that.
And we made it even simpler by keeping all of those details on the Expresso social media pages, so you've got no excuses. There is a way that you can do this easily. Trust me. The bottom line is, do it. Okay, 480,000 Rand. That's the daily estimated jackpot for the Daily Lotto today, and it could be yours, but you've got to play to find out. So good luck with that.
You've got to play to find out. Now, already, we're going to make you feel like a winner because the one and only, the man standing by to perform something called Hard Klop. And this one is by Ray J featuring KD. And I think it's a snippet of his upcoming single. This is obviously called You're Mine. But I'm talking about the one and only Liam van der Heide. Enjoy.
It's me again. My name is Liam van der Heide, for those who just joined. This next song that I'm going to sing is Hard Klop by RJ and KD. I'm a fan of local music and really promoting local artists. And this song was initially written as a Kom song, for those who know Kom. But I decided to slow the song a bit down because I think it has a really, like, a lot of potential in becoming an R&B song. So I hope you enjoy it.
In my borskas sit jou naam vas, my hartjie klop, klop, klop. Jy het my aangetas, net jou vinger op my lyf, vinger op my lyf, en jy het my deurmekaar. In my borskas sit jou naam vas, my hartjie klop, klop, klop. Jy het my aangetas, net jou vinger op my lyf, vinger op my lyf, en jy het my deurmekaar. Ek sien na toekoms nou met jou, baby, say me no. Het jy lief vir my soos ek vir jou? Say me no, say me no.
Next song is my first song that I completed writing. It's a song I wrote about my girlfriend, and it's just a song of reassurance. Basically, you can sing it to your significant other just to comfort them and to let them know that you are theirs and no one else's. So yeah, let's get into it.
Baby girl, you're mine. Been waiting all the time. It never did come easily, but now all of me is yours, a love beyond secure. You'll never know the pain or the cold you felt, 'cause everything will be ease to set your spirit free. No need to hide those feelings inside, baby, 'cause everything we are is written in the stars. You're out of this world, you're one in a million kind of girl, yeah. Finest girl in the world for sure. You make my dreams come true. Dream-dressed skies are blue, not a cloud inside you chase away. all of that which rather makes a guy go insane. You're all my pain. Every once in a while I feel so ashamed. Yeah, why am I afraid that I just ain't enough for you? I can't get enough of you. Oh, everything will be, thing will be still free. Your spirit set you free, set you free, set you free. Cause everything we are, we are, all we are, all we are is written in the stars. Oh, 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 baby girl, you're mine. Been waiting all the time. It never did, come here's a leap for now. All of me is yours, a love beyond secure. You'll never know the pain or the cold you felt. Cause everything will be ease to set your spirit free. No need to hide those feelings inside, baby. Cause everything we are is written in the stars. You're out of this world, you're one in a million, one in a billion. And when my time is up and the world has had enough for me, at least I can say I've been living at my best, I can say with my chest, yeah. And when the seas were rough and the going's getting tough for me, in the end I can say everything has been alright when there's you by my side. When my time is up and the world has had enough for me, at least I can say I've been living at my best, I can say with my chest, yeah. And when the seas were up and the going's getting tough for me, in the end I can say everything has been alright when it's yours by my side.
Clover cheese is for those who love life, where everything falls into place and melts away our cares, adding joy and stretching our imagination. Clover cheese, perfectly crafted.
Made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.